I have been to see the physio, chiropractor. Everybody cannot fix it. And last month, my first time here, you pray for me. It's amazing. Only after that, look, my knees.
You better get the yabba out of your feet. You better. You better get up out of your feet. Flew in from Dubai. What is it about some people? Somebody ought to hear just say, Lord, forgive me for complaining. Somebody ought to say it. To catch a plane and get the whole way here just to give a testimony. But when you hear no cartilage and
completely tears.
What's that?
Meniscus posterior horn is completely tears.
It was what? Completely healed.
It was completely tears. Now it's completely healed. Yeah, it's a straight now. I cannot go straight. Usually I just do it like this because I have 90-degree angle. I cannot go straight. Only one prayer is everything changed. Changed my life.
So you said earlier you couldn't do what though? You couldn't bend it or you couldn't?
Yeah, I could not bend it. And also.
And for 3 years?
For 3 years. It's been more than 3 years, but for this one.
And you were on a surgery list. You were on a list to have.
Knee replacement. Yeah.
And you have special padding.
Yeah.
And you came to the meeting.
Yes.
And you got touched.
Yes. Completely touched.
Completely.
It's changed my life. That's why I won't be here today. I won't be the witness to
you
tell everybody.
You flew in to be a room.
Yeah. I really can't wait to see you.
Look into that camera right there and just tell the people that could be questioning what you're saying and just tell them in the best way you can.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. God is amazing and I got completely healed. This is real and I won't be the testimony forever.
How long of a plane ride is that? How many hours is that?
14.
14 hours. Staying here. How long are you going to stay?
Only 4 days, and I go back to China.
To where?
China.
China.
Yeah. I have a direct line from Dubai to China, but I on purpose stop here, won't come to see you, to tell everybody this amazing story.
Amen. Welcome. Welcome, everybody. Come on, join us. Stand with us. We're just going to start in some worship. We're coming expecting tonight, excited to see some wonderful miracles. Yeah. Oh, there's nothing He can't do. Our God is so good, there's nothing He can't do. Jesus, we praise. Jesus, we come and worship. Oh, in just one word, You calm the storm that surrounds me. One word, the darkness has to retreat. Oh, in just one touch, I feel the presence of heaven. In just one touch, my eyes are open to see. My heart can't help but believe. There's nothing that our God can't do. There's not a mountain that He can move. Oh, praise the name that makes a way. There's nothing that our God can't do. Oh, will believe, for greater things, there's no power like the power of Jesus. Let faith arise, let all agree, there's no power like the power of Jesus. I will believe, for greater things.
The boy, the man, and the mission. In Pittsburgh, Billy showed me the church where his family went and the door where he used to sneak out when he was 6 and 7 years of age and escape Sunday school, then cross a four-lane busy road and arrive a few more blocks away at Grandma's house. Knocking on the door, his grandma, who he called Ma'am, would open it. Oh, Billy, your dad is gonna punish you. Just a couple years later, at the age of 9, Billy would only have weeks to live. A brain tumor. The hospital didn't like it, but Grandma, Ma'am, got permission to take Billy to a miracle service led by Catherine Kuhlman. It was a Friday morning. The church was full. 1,000 were still lined up outside, and they are in that line. When from a little side door, a wave to Grandma, come. And an usher they didn't know, says, come. And he finds them a seat. Ma'am, Billy, they had a seat in the balcony. Ma'am, Billy's grandma had said over and over to Billy, Billy, say this. When she touches me, I will be healed. Say it, Billy. When she touches me, I will be healed. Over and over. Billy, say it. Say it, Billy. Say it again. The service of praise and worship began. And during that service, oh, so many were being healed. Suddenly, the clear voice of Miss Kuhlman rang out. In the balcony, someone is being healed. Then Catherine said, bring that child to me. Billy said, 9 years of age, Billy said, I'm not going. He was sick, yes, but he was 9. He had one eye covered, yes, so that he wouldn't see double all the time. He was scared. The second time, Catherine says, bring that child. Second time, Billy says, no, I'm not going. Catherine says, ushers, bring me that child. Billy came. On the stage, a tall, thin woman, tall to a 9-year-old, with skinny fingers, reached down to the sick little boy. As her fingers and her hand was approaching him, he heard these words, his grandma's words. He heard his grandma's voice. When she touches you, you will be healed. Billy fell under the Spirit. Decades later, an usher who was there that day said, Billy, when she prayed for you, the first 4 rows of the church all fell under the Spirit. Billy was growing up and taken under Catherine's wing. Often he was giving and sharing his testimony as a story of encouragement. However, in his mid-teens, Billy decided, I'm going my way. Billy would ignore the many calls from Catherine Kuhlman because she wanted him to do what God wanted him to do. Billy was on the run from God. He said, I don't want to do that. Then his wonderful younger brother was killed by a drunken driver in a car accident. Billy's heart was broken. Now in his late teens, having already been promoted to be manager of a shoe store because he sold so many shoes, and then he moved on to selling organs, one day his mother turns up at the store, walks in, and says to him, Billy, what are you doing here? Billy hears God's voice, follows God as he directs him to a Bible school in California. Personally, Brian Mahood here, I've known Billy for over 25 years. This is a good man who works hard to serve the call of God. In this Selwyn church for decades, our friend Billy Burke has brought faith, fun, and miracles, and God's touch to bless us. From this church, we've seen a young child with over 100 allergies healed and now ministers all around the world. Hundreds have been healed, saved, and more, touched by the Master's hand. Billy Burke loves Canada. Billy Burke has blessed Canada. As a church, we have seen our friends touched and healed of incurable diseases by the love and power of God through the pastor, Billy Burke. In 2011, Selwyn Outreach Center, David Cook, and Pastor Billy, we take on Loving Toronto through an outreach called Touching Toronto. Over the next 10 years, 180 meetings, thousands came through the door, hundreds healed, hundreds saved. Across Canada, a national program for 2.5 years on television, Miracles Today with Pastor Billy Burke. Get ready, Pastor Billy is returning. Here's what you need to do. Prepare your heart for a miracle. Prepare your heart for a miracle. Find a healing promise in God's word. Find what God's saying when it comes to you. Then say it, then pray it. Like Billy's grandma said, ma'am, Billy, when she touches you, you will be healed. Billy, say it, when she touches me, I will be healed. And finally, prepare your heart by adjusting your attitude. Take communion, perhaps, yourself, to help you forgive yourself and forgive anybody and everybody. Then ask the Holy Spirit to soften your heart and get ready to receive a spiritual blessing and see yourself well.
Okay, well, welcome everybody. Glad you're here tonight, and those online as well. We just want to welcome everybody, and glad you're here on a night like this. And there's some good instruction in that video. Just turn up your expectors and be ready to receive whatever the good Lord has for you. Just going to go over a few keeping rules here. For anybody that's not familiar, the washrooms are out the center aisle to the right, down near the end of the hall there. The washrooms are there. There's no child care this evening, but the nursery, which is just out through these doors, is before you get to the washrooms on the right-hand side. The nursery is open, and the TV will be there for live streaming as well. So if anybody has children and have to be in there for a bit, you won't miss any of the meeting. And for future events, this is an important thing that we're asking. We want to keep you informed of anything, just like tonight, for instance, if for some reason a flight was delayed or the storm was going to have an effect on our meeting, we would get it out to you. And it's not always that you would be checking your social media, but we want to keep you involved, but we need your text and automated phone messaging. There's a new system we have, so if we have your text and mobile phone numbers, we can save you some inconvenience, perhaps, if that's the case. So if there's some envelopes in front of you, if we don't have that, if you're a regular member here or we already have it, you're on our list, that's fine. But if you could put your name and your text, your phone number on there legibly, and then just put it in the offering bucket when it goes by, that would help us for our future events. And it's just going to take a little canvas as to how you came to know about this event. How many people here saw it on Facebook or Instagram? Okay, if you can just put your hand up if you Facebook or Instagram. Okay, there's somebody that's taking a quick count. Okay. The sign out front, if you were driving by and happened to see our sign out front, anybody in that situation? Okay. And this is probably one of the best ways, if someone invited you, if someone personally invited you. Okay, there's a good showing of hands. That's wonderful. Quick count, Shelley. And what about our email blast that we put out about the events? Okay. Another good amount there. And finally, like I say, there's a new, it's a text message, automated phone message that we're initiating. And did anybody get that this week? Okay. Looks like that system's working well as well. So there you go. Social media's got us covered. Thanks, Shelley. Okay, remember tomorrow morning, back here at 10 o'clock, another miracle service with Pastor Billy Burke. And just before we get into that, I just want to give you a little insider instruction on how this evening will work. Just remember, Pastor Billy is listening to for the guidance of the Holy Spirit as he goes through our meeting. And when he calls out your situation, you know what you're here for, what you're fighting, then immediately get out of your seat and go to the back and come down this north wall or on your left, my right, and just line up there. We'll have a person up here and they'll allow the flow to come through here one at a time. But expect God to touch you right where you are. You're going to be in this meeting tonight, and certainly the anointing is here, the corporate anointing of our meeting. And right in your seat as you're listening to Pastor Billy and he's sharing some truths and different things, just turn up our expectors. We want to be expecting, because God can heal you right in your seat where you are. We don't have to wait to have a touch from Pastor Billy. Some will, and that's wonderful, but not always. And even when you're in the waiting line, your faith works. We want to call it a healing line rather than the waiting line. So if you just turn up your expector, God's teaching from the minute Billy calls that out, the Lord's working on that person for that situation, if they're expecting and open to receive it. And so the whole time, just be continue expecting, because he could say, it could be in your seat, it could be somewhere between there and the front. So that's we've seen so many miracles over the years in that same situation. So God's already moving there. I think that's about it for me. So we'll have the worship team come back and do a couple more worships, and we'll have Pastor Billy come out. Thanks.
Amen. You guys want to stand and just worship with us? I just believe God's got something pretty awesome happening for everybody here tonight.
Come on.
I know he's been talking about coming expecting, but just something about tonight, it's got us excited. We're just, we're ready. I know it's been a while since we've seen Billy here, and it's just, it's going to be quite an amazing night tonight, so.
Yeah.
This is the house of miracles. Come on, not this building. You're the house of miracles. Come on, say, this is the house of miracles. This is the house of miracles. If you know the Lord, you've got the miracle worker in you. The miracle worker, the greater one is in you. Now, the greater one within you is going to connect to whatever God's going to do tonight. Now, Pastor Billy comes and to some degree probably has some kind of plan, but he really doesn't have a plan because we don't know which way God's going to go. His desire will be to hear the Lord. So you might start to talk to Pastor Billy. You might think he's not listening to you. You're right. He's not listening to you. He's trying to hear what the Spirit is saying. What people don't understand, the Word of God is for all of us. He sent His Word to heal us. That's the Bible. But God does so many things to get us help. It says He put gifts in the church to help us. And this is a spiritual gift in Pastor Billy. And he's come. And there's many things I love about this guy, but I'm not going to talk about him nicely because he's here. Amen. I'll talk about him nicely when he's gone. But he's gone through cancer twice. See, he understands what you're going through. He understands. He stood up in miracle services in great pain in himself, but out there began to move in the gifts of the Spirit, but he was under attack. See, because that's an ordinary person with the call of God and the gift of God. Don't look at the outside, although he does look good. Let's say he looks good. Come on, doesn't he look good? I sure hope he wasn't praying to see snow. I sure hope he wasn't. He kept telling me, this must be a snowstorm. I said, Pastor Billy, there's not even an inch of snow. The problem is us Canadians forgot about snow. It left really early this year, and it kind of shocked some people that it even would come back. So he decided for you, now they were calling me on the way to the airport, is everything canceled up there? We're hearing everything's canceled up there in Canada. No, there might be an inch of snow. And to real Canadians, we hardly even notice that, right? So I want you to turn to someone and say, I'm going to be lively tonight. Come on, say, I'm going to be lively tonight. Come on. Say, it may be cold outside, but it's warm in here. Come on, say, it may be cold outside, but it's warm in my heart. So we're just gonna thank the Lord. And do you want Duncan to rate start, or do you want these other guys to go back in?
Okay. I'm sorry.
Would you want Duncan to start right now, or do you want the other guys?
Let's go. I'm ready to go.
Duncan, he's ready to. Well, let's welcome Pastor Billy to Selwyn Outreach Center. Don't forget tomorrow morning. I know Gord told you 10 o'clock, and another miracle service. Thank you, Pastor Billy.
Hey, come on, let's go. Nothing
is impossible when you put your trust in God.
Come on, everybody.
Nothing is impossible when you're trusting in His word. Hearken to the voice of mercy. Is there anything to ask? Well, trust in God alone and rest upon His word.
Come on, here's our part. Every hand up. It's one thing to know something, it's another thing to believe it and to trust it. It's another thing to trust it. Trust comes whenever you don't really understand what's happening. You're in a healing process, but you don't understand why it's not completely there yet. And you've got to trust them. No one person has all those answers. What I know, I believe. What I don't know, I trust. Say that with me. What I know, say, I know it's God's will. for me to be healed. I know it's God's will because it's revealed in the Word of God. So since I know that, I believe it. What I don't know is how long the process may take, what I may have to go through, who all may be involved. I have to trust. In all of your life, you're going to receive both these kinds of healing. Some that's just you're not even going to have to do anything. You believed it and it left in the same day that it came. It left after a service, after a Bible study. It left that week. But then there's things that just seem to linger on. That's not a time for you to go to sleep or to take a vacation. That's a time for you to trust God. And make sure that you're verbalizing that, because that, those, we're going to talk a little bit about that tonight, but those barbs, those words that come in and continually remind you that, you know, you're not healed. What happened to the prayers? You're not living right. It's that person you're married to. They're causing all the problem. It's that church you go to. It's that last church you came out of. There's cooties everywhere. Come on, say amen. And really, and I mean, you can begin to, when you're in pain and you're suffering and you're angry, especially when you're angry, you're quick to believe stupid things. God's faithful. You know, sometimes we don't understand a lot of the process, right? We like to read about it and we like to hear the Bible sermons on Sunday morning, but when it's you front and center and something isn't manifesting all the way, but you had prayer, you know, and then you're being forced to vacillate or maybe even compromise, you know, and satisfy some people in your own family who don't believe in healing. There's not everybody's for you. Not everybody's for you. God's for you. And he said, if I'm for you, who dare be against you? Put your hands up all over the place. Come on, say, Holy Spirit, I know you're for me. And that's all that matters tonight. I'm pursuing your presence and your power. I just admit it tonight. I need your presence and I need your power. Whatever I have to do that's pleasing to you, I want to do. I may get stretched in the process. I may be very uncomfortable. But I need a little shaken up. And I ask you tonight, be gentle with me. Be firm with me. Be strong with me. So that I can live longer and serve you more. In Jesus' name. Come on, give him a thunder of praise. Come on, give him a mighty, mighty shout. Come on, where's the whistle? Where's the clap? Celebration. Oh! It sounded like I heard a lot of girls in that celebration. And it sounded like I didn't hear too many guys. So when I say everybody, that means everybody that has a body. Everybody, everybody. So let's try this again, but let's do with just the ladies. Let's give him all of the mighty praise. Come on, the mighty, mighty praise. I don't know whether to turn you guys loose or not. I don't know. We may never live this down, but we're going to give it a go. But I'm going to need every one of you guys, young, old. Come on, I'm going to need you tonight. What they just did, we're not going to live that down. Some of us men, we need God more than they do. All right, you ready to go? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, let's give him praise. I'm here just to notice, just what I just noticed there. The volume was pretty much the same. But the women last longer. The men was up there right with the women, and then all of a sudden they just dropped. So I'm not sure what that is, but we're just going to believe that everybody's going to get a new lung capacity here tonight. Amen? You may be seated quickly all over the place. Great to be with you tonight. If it's one thing I want to share with the whole Selwyn Church, don't ever doubt my love for you. Don't ever doubt. I am here in zero weather. Don't ever doubt. Don't you ever doubt my love for you. When I left for the airport this morning, as Pastor Brian told you, and I just checked because we did get a call in my office that things were being canceled here. I didn't know what was being canceled. And I just called him and asked him, I said, is there anything being canceled there? And of course, he made me aware that I was a Florida sissy. And you all here are brave, bravado, winterized Canadians. And I said, but we're all Christians. We're all part of the same body. But my part's warm and yours is cold. So we're going to snuggle here tonight. Come on, say snuggle. Give God a big shout. Come on, come on, come on. So good to see you after a little bit of a break that we've had. But we want to make sure that our faith stays lined up. It doesn't stay lined up automatically. And we're going to be talking about that tonight. What I'd like to do is capture a couple testimonies that have survived these winter months. Some of the last times we've been together. Or maybe if you've told it before and it's a really exciting testimony, we want to hear it again. So who's here tonight? Do you have a testimony? Come to me, young man. Okay, who else? Give me about a half a dozen. If I could get a half a dozen of these stories, could I get a half a dozen? Anybody over here? You've had a healing of whatever, whatever. Here's a gentleman here. Here comes a big guy down here and a lady. Come on over just a minute, sir. One, two. Yes. Testimonies never get outdated. They're not like a loaf of bread or a quart of milk. Come on. They never get outdated. Let's get a microphone on this gentleman. Can we do that? Nick, what happened here, sir?
I've had a hip and lower back and spine pain for years. And I believe that, Pastor Billy, I was touched in your service, I don't know how many years ago it was.
Oh.
And I believe that it's continuing already tonight, and I can feel it. Wow. Something's happening.
Wow.
For me, amen.
Do you know, sir? Sir, do you know where that happened? Was it here at the church?
Yes, this church right over there.
Mm, right over there, okay.
Uh-huh. And down there.
Right down there. Yeah. Wonderful. Wonderful.
Hallelujah.
You thank him for it?
I thank him every day for
every
it.
Every day.
The Lord tells me if I come to church every Sunday, he'll heal my back to get through another week. And that's the way it's gone for a number of years. And this night...
Cut a deal with God. It's a covenant. He's a covenant kind of God. That means an agreement between two people. You know, sometimes you gotta make a deal. You know, and he loved them. He said, come, let us reason together in the book of Isaiah. Meaning, come on, let me hear what you have to say. And he's serious about taking your promises, your ideas, and he wants to hear from you.
Amen.
He wants to hear you. In one sentence, you can say, boy, I'm sorry, I've been smoking all my life, and man, I need new lung capacity. Have mercy on me. He can handle that. God can handle what people can't. People get offended on the drop of a hairpin. If you say one little thing like what I just said, they're going to come and remember the negative thing. Well, he said, I smoked all those years. Well, no, he also said that he was going to show mercy to you. But people get their very thin skin sometimes, and they get all upside down about stuff. But when you go to God, I mean, it's very important that you can come back to him and say, you know what, Lord, I've made some horrible mistakes. Eaten wrong, drank wrong, did some whatever. I need some mercy tonight. Take him at his word. He said he's rich in it. If he's rich in mercy, give me some of that. You say I'm your son, you say I'm your daughter, I'm asking you for some of that mercy. And then that's called getting healed on credit. How many know how to use a credit card? Let me see. How many understand credit? Let me see. Then you shouldn't have any problem at all tonight. You get healed ahead of your character development. If God had to wait till we were all much better people, then there would not be anybody really getting healed. We're healed on grace. We're healed on mercy. It takes faith to do that. Why does it take faith to do that? Because you got to really push past all the stupidity you've done. Because somehow we can't get past that. Why? Wrong preaching, wrong teaching has made it sound like you're being penalized now. God happens to know that his goodness causes people to change, not his judgment. You got to quit penalizing yourself. That was done 2,000 years ago at the cross. At the cross, everything was nailed there, and your stuff was nailed there, and you're supposed to leave it there. He came out of that grave. We're going to celebrate that, what, next week, I believe, right? Sometime, yeah. And you need to really make this your resurrection season, because if you're being tormented with voices of the abortions, of the affairs, of the whatever you have done, you know, and you think, I've had people write in services, well, I know why the guy upstairs don't want to heal me. Why? And they tell me. And I say, well, have you said, told God you're sorry? Well, yeah, I mean, I did confession, took communion. My God, then why don't you receive it? You got to receive forgiveness. Then if you don't, then you don't believe in the cleansing of the blood. It's that blood or all the times you took communion. Why take it if it's just a token, a religious token? That cleanses you. Never to be heard of again. Never to be made mention of in the courts of heaven. You won't have to answer for it at the judgment seat. Why carry that around here? Yeah, but then if I do that, it'll just seem like I never done it. Well, you're getting warm. You're getting the hint. That's what it's supposed to seem like. We're not supposed to carry around today's stuff and yesterday's stuff and all the classic stuff of 15 years ago. You'll get all stuffed up and stiff, and you won't be able to do anything. You won't be worth working in the church. You won't be worth, you know, being around people that are really serving God. You won't be worth, you just won't feel worth it. And you'll always be comparing yourself. Why do you do that? Because you haven't received the liberty yet, the freedom from who you used to be. There was a day you didn't even care. There was a day you just did it and everybody was doing it. But you got born again. Come on, he came in. He came in. He forgave you. I mean, he just has done an amazing work, and now the devil's trying to steal it back. You got to fight for that. You got to not fight, you already are, but you got to fight to keep it. Come on, say, I'm a contender. I got to contend for my blessing. The devil hates progress. Come on, he hates me moving forward. He does not like the word wholeness. I've been healed, but I'm on my way to whole. Come on, give him a mighty praise here tonight. Come on. That's powerful. So, hey, sir. So how long did you have that back issue? How long?
Since I was 15 in high school.
What did you do? How did you hurt it?
Kicked in the tailbone, clowning around with some friends, kicking at each other with steel-toed boots on. Dumber than dirt.
Dumber than dirt. Now there's a new one for me right there. Dumber than dirt.
Yeah.
Lord, don't let me ever repeat that again, please. That's terrible. Terrible talk, my grandmother would say. That's terrible talk. I'd say something, Billy, that's terrible talk.
I said he was dumber than dirt, not anymore.
Not anymore. Is your wife here? Are you married?
I'm single all my life, have been.
Single all your life?
Yes, have been all my life.
Close your eyes. We're going to fix this.
No. No, we're not. Leave the man alone. Yeah. Get him.
I was going to put him up for auction. Come on. Who am I? Hey, oh. I do know that. I do know that. I even know where it is.
I'm 66 years old, pretty content the way I am. The Lord is good to me.
That's a wonderful story.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
You're happy. Yeah.
Now that's a strong word.
Yeah.
That's not a lot of word people can genuinely say.
No, I suppose.
You're happy.
I'm happy.
Some people don't even have the first two letters of that word. Which is ha, ha, come on. Let alone P-P-Y. Amazing. And your name again?
Terry.
Have we ever met Terry? You know, that time we prayed for you.
I think you were over there. But yeah. You didn't know my name. Uh-huh. You didn't know my name.
I'm so excited for this story.
I'm so happy.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
That mighty power of the Holy Ghost will give him praise. He don't know whether to stand up or fall. He's trying to decide. And they're helping him back to his seat. And we're just getting started. It could be a long night. I don't know. Good to see you guys. Good to see you, Miss Jane. You doing good? Good to see you. And you came from where?
About 5 minutes.
Well, you're not the daughter that's way out there then. That's right here. Oh, from McMurray. Or, is that it? Oh, wow, okay. What happened to you, young man?
In 2021, I had a brain injury.
A brain injury, okay.
And I had 3 seizures after that within the first 2 years. And my last one was in July of 22. And I've been seizure-free since, but 2 weeks ago I had a seizure when I was driving.
Oh. So you've been seizure-free for a lot of years.
Yeah, almost 2 years. But I had a seizure 2 weeks ago. Had my parents in the car with me, and they're driving instructors, so we're...
You got to take your healing serious. A lot of people don't. They don't think there's any more maintenance involved after you get a healing. Wrong. It's the favorite place for him to strike. He wants to make God look like a Cinderella God. You don't keep it long. You have a night out, a month out, a week, and maybe even a year. Then that cancer comes back. They always use the word with a vengeance. That journey, when you get healed, that is something you're going to be eternally, yes, but every day grateful for. Because it changes your life. It's meant to change your life. And if you're planning on living till the rapture, come on, say, till the rapture, you're going to need probably more than a couple more healings. So you're going to need to pull on that, touch that hem yet again and yet again and yet again. And you want to make sure that you were eternally grateful the first couple of times. Because the Bible proves it out that he's very aware of who comes back to thank him. There were 10 lepers, and how many came back? And he said what, weren't there? He counted. I said he counted. You say numbers don't matter? They matter to God. So if he counted and he knew all the people that he had healed, all 10 lepers, he's saying, where's the 9? He was expecting them to come back with gratitude too. God expects you to send a thank you card. We do it well with people when they give us gifts. We send them a thank you card. And we put a little note in there and thank you so much for the, you know, the dinner certificate or the flowers, whatever. We're good with that. But there's somebody else in our life that really needs to be thanked. There's no such thing as a small healing. The littlest of things can take away the quality of your life. If you don't have a little toe, it knocks off your whole balance. You know, one of the Pittsburgh Steelers, one of the meanest people that played on the Pittsburgh Steelers, had to retire early because of his little toe. I'm not going to say his name because he might come after me. But I'm saying this, that's I just know that from inside people. So don't take anything lightly, a deliverance from an addiction that you don't have to carry the rest of your life, that your wife don't have to live with, or your children don't have to see you in that way, and then they quit believing in church. They see you putting all your time in church and your money, and you can't get help. You can't change the way you talk. You never wonder, why do you even go? Because, see, they know if you take steroids, you get muscles. They know if they drink a lot of beer, you get drunk. They know if you take a lot of drugs, you get, you know, druggy. See, they're used to those quick fixes. They see results. So they get into that world of what? In the world of the five senses. And they expect results. You're coming here and come home for every week, and they're not seeing any results. That makes them think, I have more going where I am than you do where you're going. That's why it's important that when we do get a touch of God, then it is a growing. You are a miracle in motion, as we sang earlier. It's important that you thank him the whole way through it. I thank you, my eyes are even better this year than last year. I thank you that I had to get a new set of hearing aids. Maybe the first ones you couldn't get rid of, you still needed some. Maybe there was nerve damage. Maybe one of the little bones in there was cracked. But there's improvement. Improvement is progress. Progress is healing. And every time you thank him, I mean, he's touched by it and the devil's disturbed by it. I enjoy disturbing the devil. Come on, I enjoy disturbing. Say that, I enjoy disturbing the devil. Boy, whenever you can mess up his strategies and throw it back in his face and move on down the highway anyhow. There's quite a few overcomers here in this church. I've been coming here for a few years, and I see a lot of your faces. You say, yeah, but I'm still... Well, everybody struggles. There's not a person here that doesn't struggle. That's a sign you're still alive. That's a sign you haven't been overtaken by darkness, that you're still struggling. Come on, give God a shout for that. Come on. Come on. But like that man that was here, now this guy here, he had that... He came back. How long was you seizure-free?
It would have been 2 years this July.
2 years. All of a sudden, you get one.
You said the devil doesn't like progress. I finished my schooling this past January.
Right.
From my crash.
Right. But when something does come back like that, you got to realize, wow, this, see, he put it together. Connecting these dots is crucial. Because he wants to take those seeds that are planted in you and take them away from your life and keep you at minimal function. He don't mind if you're saved just so you don't do anything. He don't mind if you get healed just so you don't tell anybody. Do you hear me? So there's compromise the whole way through this. And you don't want to drink that cup. That cup of compromise, you don't want to drink that. You won't be at peace with yourself, because you'll know that God deserves way more from you than what we're giving him. I believe we're in this coming down the home stretch. I believe the days of the glory are here. Yeah, you're not going to feel the flu coming on you. You're not going to feel a fever coming on. You're going to begin to say, honey, I just feel like I'm in another planet. Something's happening here. And it won't be a stroke. It's going to be the glory's coming on you.
Hallelujah.
Right in your house, the glory. And you may be out of commission for a couple hours. You may have to sit in the lazy chair and get lazy. Come on, can you say amen?
Amen.
You may have to swim down Lazy River and just enjoy God for the rest of the night. Honey, come on, we got to go to bed. I'm not moving. Why not? There's something moving all through me. And God's turning back time. Giving me a new heart, taking all the cholesterol out of my system. You could be on the verge of being set up for an angelic visitation.
Hallelujah.
I just talked to one of my pastor friends in Kentucky. It's where the Colonel Sanders got saved. And he was telling me he woke up here, I don't know, maybe about a month ago. He just woke up at about 2-3 o'clock, and there's an angel sitting on his bed. I said, no, wait a minute. Was it in the spirit? Or he said, Billy, he was sitting on my bed, and the wings were folded. I said, what in the world did you do? He said, I froze. I didn't know what to say. I didn't say, what are you doing here, right? You don't say that to the angel. And the angel looked at him and said, I want you to go down to this building in Louisville, Kentucky. I want you to go down to this building. I want you to make this amount of money offer, and this whole building will be yours for less than half the price. Because he was looking for a place to do some feed people. And so he said, I just did what the angel said. He went down, and I said, what happened? He said, we got the building for half the price, a little less than that. And he said, everybody's happy. It's packed out already, and we're feeding thousands of people. So See, the reason the Bible says entertain, be careful, you're not entertaining angels unaware, it don't mean it's just maybe people, you don't recognize them. I guess that's one definition. Unaware means you don't know when they're coming. You don't know when they're coming. I mean, after me saying this tonight, I guess a few of you are going to get a couple. I don't know, but. And there's people, there's angels that bring money, angels that bring healing, it's angels that bring confirmation. They're minister, they come to minister. They don't come just to scare you or say you had a visitation. They come with some good news that's coming from God. They work in conjunction with the Holy Spirit. That Holy Spirit's probably the one that orchestrates their path. They're dispatched on your behalf. You've had them in your room, you just haven't seen them yet. So tonight when you go home, when you're in your bedroom, when you turn the lights up, here's what, I know you're here. Come on, somebody. Don't manifest right now, I'll die right here on the spot. But I know you're here, and when you know I'm ready, let me see you. Nothing wrong with that. I'm so tired of preachers telling people, I'll quit seeking that stuff. Why not? Everything in here is for us. Everything in here. That's why John the Baptist, you know, whenever Jesus said, you know, you baptize me. That was his cousin. And John the Baptist says, why would I baptize you? You're Jesus. And here's what Jesus said, that all righteousness, say that all righteousness, might be fulfilled. Everything I'm supposed to experience, Jesus, everything I'm supposed to experience here, I want it. Every feeling, every touch, every experience, whatever that may be, I don't want to leave here thinking I didn't get to see it all. Come on. I mean, that's like going to Lake Mead and you miss Hoover Dam. Come on, say amen. You want to see the whatever. You want to see the Eiffel Tower at night and in the day. Who wants to go to Niagara Falls and it's froze? You don't see anything falling over the... I went to Niagara Falls, it was froze. What'd you think of that? I wanted to see the falls, it froze. Couldn't go on the sea mist. I couldn't go get any of the spray. I will go back. You want the whole thing. Come on, you want the burrito supreme. Come on, can you say amen? Come on, give God a big shout here tonight. Come on, come on. But that comes from within. And if you're used to being deprived, if you're used to just getting by and not having all of that, then you carry that beggarly spirit into the kingdom. And you think that is, well, I'm content. That's not contentment. Contentment is just simply you're not complaining. That's complacency. You don't want to get complacent. Not when there's more right around the corner. No matter what your age is. You don't outgrow God's blessings because you get older. Matter of fact, when you get older, I think we need them more. How many is getting older here tonight? Let me see. How many is getting older? I got to raise my hand too. Come on. I got. Don't we still need to see more?
Yes.
So this stuff that you haven't yet experienced, that should be high on the list or in your bucket list. It should be there. While you're still breathing, while you're still looking down at the grass, while you serve the God of the impossible, while everything you read is you can have it. We got to go after that. Quit reading magazines because you can't even have better homes and garden. You don't have a better home or a better garden. Yet that's all you read. You read muscle magazines. Look at you. You guys like those car magazines. You rode a bicycle here tonight in the snow. Come on. You're reading stuff that you're not able to grab. This book will give you the faith to get everything that you're after. Just by reading it. You don't even have to memorize. Just read it. There's a power. There's a real power to reading this book. It'll heal you. It'll put you in position to be prosperous. And you'll never have to worry another day about retirement or living long. How many want to live long? How many want to live long and strong? How many want to know everybody around in your life? You want to know their names. It's powerful. Too many people today just settling for less. Well, I'm glad I'm alive, but you don't know anybody. It's important that you grab a hold of wholeness. Come on, reach your hands up right now. Let's do it. It's important. Don't let anything slide by you. Don't take anything for granted. Maybe you're not fighting it today, but maybe there's symptoms. Maybe there's a little bit of signs, you know, that we're mortals here. We're mere mortals that are filled with the Spirit. It's not our mortality that calls on God. It's the Spirit within us. Come on, say, Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
I don't want nothing to get by me tonight. My ears are sensitized. My heart is in good position. My faith is on target. I'm going out on a limb with you tonight. And I'm wanting you to come to my tree and manifest something in my body, in my mind. I want to muzzle these demonic voices. They don't control me. They never did. They never will. Tonight is my night to carry the glory. Come on, give him a mighty, mighty shout. Come on. Come on. That's amazing. That's amazing, and I don't want that to set you back. I don't want that to set you back. That was just a sign maybe that, you know, your foot's off the pedal a little bit. You take your foot off the pedal. You can't do that. Do you hear me? Yes. You don't get Spirit-filled not to use more of the Spirit. When you get Spirit-filled, it's God saying, oh, here's more Spirit to use. And you got to keep the pressure on what? On every yoke you've ever had. Because the easiest place for you to lose and to get in trouble is where you've come from that you already had. The devil's going to hit that first before he does anything new to make sure that door is closed.
Thank you, Lord.
Keep thanking him. Keep praising him.
Praise
you, Lord. I was healed of cancer the first time in 1962 at a Catherine Kuhlman service. I don't know that I thank him every day, but close. But close. To what? To remind God? No, to remind me. That I'm grateful. That we can't be a bunch of spoiled king's kids. We get healed and forget about it. We don't even remember it. And then we just expect more without, you know, being able to really be thankful. That's why there's so a lot of people don't worship. Because they're not grateful for what God did. Then you get into entitlement. And you get healed because you're God's kid. That's not healthy. It's not healthy. It's really it builds a really weak legacy. And it makes your healing cheap. You don't want cheap stuff. We come from a rich God who paid for our sins with his blood. He couldn't carry his own cross. He couldn't pound himself to the cross. He needed help from what? From the enemies. He laid everything down, did not resist because he had to pay that price. They even offered him on the way wine mingled with gall. It was opium. It was a painkiller. He tasted it and spit it out. Why did he spit it out? Because he couldn't go to the cross numb. He had to feel the pain for you and for me. Come on, say he's amazing. Give him a mighty, mighty praise. Come on. Oh, come on. You got to give him a mighty, mighty shout. I mean, if you've been victimized through the years, he's stolen stuff from you. You got to say, you know what? This is a new season. You're never going to steal my praise. You're never going to steal my worship to my God. You're never going to steal my testimony. There ain't nothing. I mean, these are the most valuable things in the believer's life. Yes. Since you became born again. Your value system just changes. Boy, and then you build that path to the throne. And when you come in, he knows why you're coming before you even get there. And you get healed after healed after healed after healed. This guy, I remember your story. I think it's a remarkable story, number one. And I never thought each time that I left here that it was really complete yet. So he's nipping at your heels. He don't want you to get the full story here. He don't want you to get that, because this story here, just shake all the... Where do you live? Peterborough?
Havelock, but yeah.
Where do you live?
Havelock.
Avalon? It'll shake all Avalon.
Havelock.
Well, whatever it is, and wherever it is. I get in trouble up here with all these names. Napanee and what else? Some of these names are just Indian names, right? Kimosabi. I love it. I love it. I think it's wonderful. But I think you ought to understand that this anything you gain, you're going to have to contend to protect it. Any healing you get, any amount of money you get, any anointing that God gives you, there's always somebody with skin on or spiritual forces that want to steal it from you. And you have to count it valuable. Come on, so you can't have it back. I'm healed. I'm not going back. I'm not dead. I'm alive. I'll fight you with the name, the blood, and the word. Come on. Give him one more mighty praise, I'll tell you. Come on. Come on. I think this is marvelous. So then you had one seizure in how many years? Two,
yeah. I had one in December of 21 after my injury, and then two in 22.
Don't lose that, please.
And then one just a couple weeks ago.
Where do you go to church?
Here.
Right here. Put your hands up. Put your hands up. Oh, good. You're going a little bit better with that.
Yeah, it's coming.
It is. I see that. Master, we thank you for this wonderful touch that you gave this young man. And the devil must see danger ahead, because he's coming after with these symptoms. And I pray tonight that you would just once and for all put an axe to the root.
Thank you, Lord.
I mean, from head to toe, these arms begin to loosen all the restrictions. Whatever strategy he's using on you, God's going to give you grace tonight to beat that. Those thoughts, he's going to give you grace to get that stuff out of your head. You hear me? By that Holy Ghost we give you. Oh, wow. Come on, somebody give God a shout. Come on, you can get a little bit excited here. Oh! What happened to you?
I have so many testimonies.
You do? Well, just give me one.
So this is my first testimony, my baby blessing. So you
couldn't get pregnant?
I had some hormonal issue and I had thyroid. So when I came in Canada, I knew that it's difficult to find doctor here, especially for the internationals. But I started believing. I was not a born Christian. Even my whole family were against me.
Wow.
They are still against me.
Wow.
But I put everything on God. So I believed God gonna help me. So first time in my life, I came in church when you came here in August 2022.
Yes.
And that day, Holy Spirit touched me. God opened the doors and in different ways.
Uh-huh.
I went to my workplace. I met with a nurse.
Uh-huh.
And we started communication. And she came back from her maternity leave.
Mm-hmm.
And I asked her, like, how do you find the doctor? And she helped me everything. She put a form and everything. I got my doctor appointment. I got family doctor within 1 month.
Uh-huh.
And after that, I have never seen that girl. She was a divine helper for me.
You're thinking she might have been an angel, right?
Yes. I started to come in this church.
Yeah.
Pastor Brent, Pastor Linda, they encouraged me. Because I was a new believer, I had no idea about Jesus. Even I did not know what is the meaning of hallelujah. Nothing. I was very new believer.
Precious.
My husband, he started, when I started to come in the church, we had a huge fight. And he said, why are you going to the church? I said, I don't know, but something is pulling me.
Yeah.
I don't know. So my treatment started when I healed from here. So I conceived the baby. That was my first blessing. And after that, still my husband did not believe at me, even in the Jesus. He said, no, nothing is. And he said to my, he called to my family in India, and he said, I'm not going to live with her if she is still going to the church.
Oh.
Why she is not marrying, why you did not find a Christian guy if she believe in God? And I said, when I married to him, I was not a believer.
Yeah. And well, you're I wouldn't want to fight with you. She's quick, huh? That's quick.
Yeah. So after that, something happened with him. So firstly, he was trying to give the aged truck license, mm-hmm. and he failed 3 times.
Oh.
And I asked
He's
him.
He's not here, right?
No.
Okay.
So
he has been.
Oh, good. So I asked him, "You come to the church with me one." Oh. And we pray there. Mm-hmm. First, he did not agree, and then he came. Pastor Brand prayed, and he passed his license.
You're due this week, aren't you? 2, 3.
Very soon. Doctor said baby can come anytime.
Well, this is the healing and deliverance service. That's what yeah. this is.
And her husband saw so many prayers answered that wow. he kept telling her to go to church
wow.
because things have changed in India. All sorts of miracles have happened, right? Look at that face.
That's special.
Yeah, something happened in India, like some family issue, and lawyer told to my husband he has to go back to India
oh.
and solve the issue. But he did not want to go back. He just came in 2022. And Lord said, you have to go back.
Oh.
And I told him, you have to come to the church with me. And he
sounds
came.
Sounds like you're taking over this family. That's what it sounds like.
He came and he prayed. And in one night, everything changed.
One night, everything changed.
Yeah. Yeah. So he booked his ticket. To Facebook at his flight, he started packing everything, and suddenly we found a lawyer, and he said, you don't have to come back to India, you stay in Canada, and he will do start process online.
Favor is falling.
Yeah. Then he started believing.
Mm-hmm. Don't push it, lady, don't push it.
I don't
know when to back off. Honey, that's amazing. Just walk away. Come on, son. Just walk away. Do all that up there with him, but not with the husband. That's great. That's so great.
I don't push him even, like, I don't force him. You come. He's still up and down, on and off. When he's in the trouble, he come with me.
She don't push him. Not at all.
But he's not stopping me.
Glorify thy name, glorify thy name, glorify. Hands up, come on, glorify. Power's all over you. Just that's the power, lady. That's the power. Oh Lord. If you fall, we will have a deliverance service, I'll tell you that. Hold her, keep her up. Just hold on to her. Hold on to her. Rarely do you say tell me say don't fall, right? But this we just don't wanna. This baby looks like it could come out tonight. Are you due now? Are you due? At any time. Oh, geez. Go sit down. Take her back to her seat. Take her back to the seat. Give her a pillow. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So back in November, the last touch in Toronto.
Oh.
Actually, it starts about a month before that or more. No. My wife had very severe pneumonia. And this went on.
Antibiotic resistant from medicine.
Yeah. So she went through two rounds. Actually, she went through the first round of antibiotics, and it started getting worse. And we went back to the doctor. We prayed, of course. But we went back to the doctor, and she did a second round, and it still wasn't doing anything, and she kept getting worse. And a couple of weeks before the meeting was coming up, I mean, I was going to work, and at one point I told my boss, I said, one text, and I'm out. I was calling her every hour.
Right, right.
Because her breathing. Mm-hmm. And finally, the day of the meeting coming, we were Faith and I had been bugging her to get to the hospital. And she said, well, the doctor puts me in. I don't want to go to the waiting rooms and all this stuff to get nothing. But her breathing was getting shallower and shallower. And we came into that meeting, touching Toronto, because I was ushering there. And I actually texted Cheryl just before we left. I texted Cheryl and I said, because ushers get reserved seats. I said, let my wife sit with me. And when I walked into that sanctuary and sat her down, honest to God, I looked and I said, wow. Dear God, do not pray to go home, because she was that close. Her breathing was so shallow, she couldn't stay awake. She doesn't remember.
I don't remember.
Wow. Your oxygen was saturated.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, down to about 15% probably.
What?
There was a choice that day, the hospital or the meeting. Had she not been touched, we would have been
going to
the hospital in Scarborough. But I was very scared. I was trying to do serve, but I was very scared. I'm thinking, God, if
so
she
you came
prays
to the meeting.
Right, pray.
Hurry up, you came
and,
to the meeting.
And then you called for something, and I came up to get a touch, and you had you declared that God was widening my arteries. I had narrowing arteries. And you said I'd be running around the house chasing my wife. Where is she? And then you went over and we got up and you laid hands. Well, that was towards the end, so we probably stayed about a half an hour and then a half an hour ride home. By the time we got to bed, maybe an hour after we got home, her oxygen levels, she was breathing normal. She was praising God. She just vibrated. The Holy Spirit, she vibrated in the Spirit for a good three
she
or four
what?
Days.
Vibrated?
Like just.
What do you mean vibrated?
It's like you could just feel the Holy Spirit kind of. It's like having a muscle.
4 days!
Until it was gone.
4 days? That's a makeover for 4 days. You got more taking, huh?
There was three rounds of heavy-duty antibiotics that did nothing. And I knew that if I went to the hospital, I'm not coming out. They're going to intubate me. That's going to be it.
Right.
And it's like, hospital?
Two most dangerous
service.
Places
Let's
on
go
earth
with the
today.
One that
two
works.
Most dangerous places, the womb of a woman and a hospital. How sad is that? I don't want to put fear in you, but you want to just quit looking to everything like that as your source. They works with God, but don't be seeking that stuff first.
Amen.
Seek ye what? Seek ye first the rule of God. Seek ye first. If the hospital plays into that, great. If it's an emergency, that's different, right? But just begin to wear that path out in pursuit of getting used to going to God. Here I am. I need you. I'm your daughter. I'm your son. I need help. Touch my back, my eyes, my ears, my sleep. Abbreviate this chemotherapy. Abbreviate the dialysis. That's why we pray. We don't pray just to pray. I don't pray just to pray. I pray for intervention. Come on, say, I'm expecting intervention. I'm expecting God to step in. In the meeting, in the car, on the way home. Sometime that week, I'm expecting him to step in. That's why we sing. That's why we pray. We're not that pure that we just sing all the time because we love God. We need him. And he knows we need him. And that praise, even though we're singing to him, is just as much for you as it is him. because it creates a different climate on the inside of you. It gets rid of a lot of crazy stuff that we pick up throughout the day or throughout that week. I mean, a little bit of praise can detoxify you like that. That's why we emphasize, come on, sing with us. We can't make you sing. But we do that. That's why you have worship leaders. That's why this, don't they do a great job here? They do a great job here. And that's made just so you follow along with them. People don't take it serious. They just think, well, no, I'm just following a song leader. Well, if that's all you make it. But if you take that and you worship him, Lord, everything we just sang, I mean it. I don't talk to you enough, and so I'm here to do it in the group. The group is supposed to motivate you to become what? To be able to do this on your own. That's the encouragement of a group, of the public meeting, the corporate structure. It's supposed to make you hungry to go home and try this by yourself and increase that presence and increase healing so things don't get worse. Right? Is that right? Is that right? You correct me if I'm wrong, okay? Just ring the bell. Well, there's no bell here, though. We'll find one. That's an amazing story. That's an amazing story. That's a miracle story.
Our daughters were just completely just...
Your daughters were what?
Just completely flabbergasted. And they grew up in this church. And they were still kind of like...
But they saw it happen to their mother.
Oh, put it on YouTube.
Back to what I was saying. They had it on YouTube.
Make them watch it.
They put it on YouTube.
Yeah.
That's it.
He kept coming along every couple minutes and putting his fingers...
You're both talking way too much. You're both talking way too much. Too much, too much, too much, too much, too much. Come on, somebody give God a big shout. Come on. Woo! Let him just continue to say, Lord, make me whole. Make me whole. Watch him. Make me whole. Amen. Great story. Great story. I love it. You're telling everybody? You ought to get a track of that made. Would you put it on YouTube or? Oh, that's true. But you should put it on.
I just kept sharing it, saying, this is where you want to look. And they can see where he keeps coming over and checking to see if I'm still breathing.
You know, when it goes back to that word, those arteries widened. There probably was maybe something with your carotid arteries. You probably got plugged up with stuff. God opened them up and saved her life. It's wonderful. Is this your home church? Is this your home church?
We're in Oshawa, so we get out here as often as
we can. We try to. We're in between right now. We try to have a local church that we can serve at.
That's good.
Really, and then come out here. We've been coming out here. Well, we were here the first time you were here.
Okay. Well, this is Pastor Brian. You're pastor at large.
Yeah. Yes. Well,
right?
Yes, he is.
It's a home away from home. We're just glad for you to be here tonight and testify. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Come on, give him a big, big God bless you. What happened here?
About 6 or 7 years ago, I was sitting over there.
You were sitting over there 6 or 7 years ago?
With my wife, and you called me out. And I says, oh, you didn't even get to pray for me.
Ah.
I just go down in the spirit and told my wife, and he says, he's been healed of a widowmaker.
Of a widowmaker?
Yeah. And like I knew this. Because the heart issues fell in my family. Like sometimes I would pass out for no reason at all.
Oh.
And like even a few years before that.
But I didn't know that.
No, you didn't know that. No. No idea. So even before that, the doctor put a monitor on me. You know, you wait for 2 days or something. But they couldn't find nothing.
Let's get this story. I'm going to put this. I like this story here.
But the amazing thing is a year later, I went to Evangel Temple.
We were holding meetings there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so I snuck up with somebody else, and you, well, he says, that's not the issue. So you put your hand on my head, and he says, oh, there's some lobes in the brain.
Wow, wait.
And nothing.
Why do you want to keep coming to see me? I don't know why.
Yeah. Like you said, you got to keep coming back and get...
This is his annual checkup. He comes to get checked up here. Free medical attention here. Special.
I got type 2 diabetes.
Oh, ho, ho, ho!
So it's time to get rid of that, right?
I like that thinking. I like that. He did it. He did it. He did it. He'll do it again. He'll do it again. He'll do it again. And he's testifying. He's doing it right. Don't get healed and keep it to yourself. That's not the reason you got healed. It's your story at first. Then it becomes the kingdom story. You represent the kingdom wherever you are. Very, very important that you're not bashful about this. There's people out there being brutalized. These girls are still in the tunnels over in Gaza. They'd love to be standing here giving a testimony. So think of people like that that are still in harm's way, crying for freedom. Nobody can hear them except God. It's very, very important that you use your freedom. Your freedom can go right over there into those tunnels. If you really, I mean, your prayers can go into those tunnels. The pastor we were talking today, he said there's, what, over 500 of those tunnels? Pastor, where'd you go? He stepped out. He's like Jesus, just disappears on you. Shows up and disappears. Where'd he go? This is a grace. Is your wife here tonight? Bring your wife. Where's the wife? Come here, ma'am. Come here. Yeah, there's a touch on both of you. It's honor. It's one. It's honor. It's honor. It's honor. My word. Dear God, you don't have a chance, sir. You don't. Fire the Holy Ghost. Come on, give God a big, big shout. Boom. Come on, give him a big, big shout. Woo! Yes, sir, what happened to you?
Last year, November 27, and you're in Touch Toronto.
Touching Toronto.
You know, you touched me. I didn't feel at that moment. And 2 weeks later, I feel totally changed inside me. I just feel something happened here in my chest, in my heart. Mm. I just don't know what happened. And Sarah called me. Sarah said, "Oh, Peter, do you know the last time that Brother Billy touched you, you got powerfully touched?" Oh my God! I said yes. As right now, I feel something changed in me.
Yeah.
I just feel the glory inside me.
It's beautiful.
You know, that is so strange. I say nobody will believe it. I said the glory is too strong. I have to get out of my body. Yeah. See, this one nobody. You know, I said if I don't say something. So I put in a video. At that moment, I videoed, say whatever I'm feeling. I said, if you pass this moment, I cannot test me. I may not believe myself. And try to get the speaker in tongues, but that never happened. And 2 weeks later, you touch me, and the tongues come back.
The tongues came back.
The tongue, yeah, I have tongues. The first time I have tongues, they automatically come. And still some pastor said, and the ball move.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I never feel. But I feel something like a wing is a flow here, is like here. I totally come back.
I don't know what you're saying, but I believe it.
Yeah. Yeah, the ball is moving.
I get everything. I heard it in my spirit. Yeah. Sometimes you hear with your ear, sometimes with your spirit.
Yeah.
And I'm hearing with my spirit with you.
This is totally changed me. From 2018, I tried to looking for tongues. Automatically looking for speaking in tongues.
You were looking to speak in tongues.
But this never happened.
Okay.
And that moment, 2 weeks later, you touched me and everything come back.
Tongues, everything.
Tongues and ball movements. And the glory inside here.
My God, you're a walking kingdom. Where do you go to church?
In Toronto.
Where?
Toronto.
In Toronto.
In Toronto.
She came all the way out here in this weather tonight to be here.
Yeah, I think I just need more of the glory. I need more touch. this is my testimony.
By the Holy Ghost, by the Holy Ghost. Somebody better give God a shout. Come on, wow. Anybody else over here? Hey, Jerry, you doing okay? You was on my mind all day today. And I asked, I asked Pastor, I said, have you seen Jerry? Come on, have you seen Jerry? And I just wanted to make sure you're doing okay.
I came here tonight to get a refill.
A refill.
I walked through the valley and I realized you don't walk alone. God's given me a promise. He told me that no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind can imagine what God has prepared for those that love Him. And I know that that's where Janet is.
Remember that, you know, passing into the next life. None of us, how many want to go to heaven? Let me see, you really want to go? How many want to go right after the service? See, that's my point, is that we all like it until it's your turn. And all of a sudden we think there's something wrong with that. No. We don't hear enough about it. There is a place. There's people there right now. His wife is there, Janet. My mother, my grandmother's there, my brother. I mean, I think I'm the only one left in my family, my immediate family. They're all there. And Dr. Piper, who was killed in a car wreck, I believe, and an angel came and took him out of the car, and he was in heaven for, I forget, 8 minutes or something like that. So I brought him in. I'd spend time with him. He said, Billy, in heaven, nobody misses you in heaven. They expect you. They don't miss you. They don't think about earth. They know you're coming. Why would you miss somebody that's coming? It's really, really important that we do as much as we can to get that fear out of us and work our faith at believing that there is a place that we step into. That's the ultimate healing. That's not when you lose the battle to something. That's the ultimate healing. God took Enoch out of here because Enoch was too good to live here. Enoch was just too good. He didn't want Enoch to get contaminated with the ways of the earth. Enoch walked and walked and walked and just was not. So we got to get our heads right on this, because there are people that are leaving. And I don't like it when people indicate to me that they lost the battle. They may have lost a battle, but they won the war. That's why you get born again, is to secure your eternal destiny. So to live dangerously is to never be, to be in all these meetings and never accept Jesus as your Savior. And you believe there's all these different ways to heaven. You're risking forever to be just to believe something that really, really isn't true or founded. Tonight, before you leave this auditorium, accept Jesus. Ask Him to come in and take back your life. He may have been in charge at one time, but maybe life has drifted you away from Him and you're no longer depending on Him. That's why you have fear. Fear is because, you know, because the faith and the love isn't present. When you put your trust in Him for everything, your health, your money, your marriage, your children, to clean up your past, all of that stuff that's why He's there. He said, I'm the author and I'm the finisher. I'm the Alpha, I'm the Omega. In my Father's house are many mansions. I wouldn't lie to you. If it were not so, I wouldn't tell you. And I understand nobody wants to go tonight because we still think this is a better place. It's not. The most beautiful spot on this planet is a garbage dump in heaven. It's pretty scary to say that. We get all excited because a bird talks, a parrot says hello, and a porpoise jumps through a hoop. Come on, we get all thrilled that that stuff happens. Oh, look at this, look at that. Heaven is just so, the plants talk. The trees of the field clap their hands. The glory. You're headed for somewhere. What did Paul say? I can't even talk about it. It's beyond description. Somebody put your hands up and say, I thank God. He is God. I accepted him before, and I'll do it again tonight. He is my Lord, and all of my faith, all of my trust is in him. In him I live and move and have my whole being. Give him a mighty praise. Can you do that? Come on, can you do that? Put your hands up, Jerry. All I'm hearing the Lord say is that for whatever reason, we didn't know this was Janet's time. We just didn't know it. But everything that he promised that he was going to do with both of you, you're still here. And he's going to do it with you. And in so doing with you, it's going to bring healing because you're going to say, Janet, it's happening. Everything you and I was believing for and prayed for, it's here. And then you just say to the Lord, Lord, let her peek over the balcony and see it. Let her just, come on, go like that, everybody. Just let her peek over the balcony and see it. We can't talk to the people that have gone because that's not right, but we go, Holy Spirit. I tell the Holy Spirit all the time, tell my mother I said hello. I go through the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, he's the mediator between heaven and earth. He's the only mediator. Come on, say, he's the only mediator between heaven and earth. Some days I miss my mother so much I could just cancel everything and just cry all day. And I don't want to do that. So I say, Holy Spirit, tell my mother that I'm just grateful for the prayers and all the support. Tell her I miss her. And then I've released the proper way. It's important that you don't just let things get clogged up in you and get weird. Tell your neighbor tonight, don't get weird on me. Tell your neighbor, come on. I love you, sir. Come on, give God a big, big shout. I don't know who I'm here for. Come on. Any testimonies over here? I thought there was one over here we didn't get. Come on, ma'am. I thought it was a... Come on, come on. With that blue sweater on and the scarf, my word. You act like it's cold outside. Come on. What happened to you?
I was healed years ago of breast cancer. And then you had a meeting here years later and said... And you said, if there's anybody here that's fearing it coming back, any kind of cancer, come forward. You're going to get prayer.
Wow.
Don't fear. It's never coming back. Well, I had an exam a few years ago. It's been a few years now. But they thought it had come back, and they put metal in to check it and put markers in and everything. And I went out of the dressing room, and I said, no. The prophet said,
"Oh,
I am not getting cancer again, so I am not." And I went back and I waited for the report and I was like, okay, Lord, you work this out.
I love this story.
And long story short, the report came back negative. There's nothing there. And and the fear, because that was the fear when
Linda, make sure I get that story. See, here's a situation where she got a prophetic word not knowing when she was going to use it. She got a prophetic word ahead of recurring cancer. She gets a word. Why does God give you a word? Because you're going to need it. If you get a money word, get ready for some warfare. You're all happy. Oh, my God, he said tonight that I'm coming into riches. Get ready. There's going to be some fighting to get a hold of that money. I got a word tonight about our marriage is going to be back on the rock, off the rocks, onto the rock. Get ready. Because the devil hears these words too. You've got to be willing to contend for this. So she hears a word about you're not going to have reoccurring cancer, right? And she's, oh, Lord, hallelujah. Now, what she did was smart. She said, I had a word for this. See, a lot of you would forget about it. You would just cave into the report. She said, nah, that don't match up with the word I got. You get a word, you take it home. It may not make any sense at all tonight, but you take that home and you stick that in your bread box, your Holy Ghost bread box, come on. And you right when you need it, and she needed it because the reports came back. That's what the devil does. Understand something about the devil. He can't help being the devil. He never gets saved. He never gets included in our birthright. He's forever a thief and a murderer. He's forever a deceiver. And he's going to try and steal something from you all the days of your life. He's in relentless pursuit of stealing your story and making you check out of here early. So it's very, very important that when you get these words, you may think, what's that? That doesn't even mean anything. Hold on to it a while. Hold on to it a while. You know, you'll be surprised what, you know, and you'd be just surprised what could happen to it. You know, this lady got healed. She was to come up and she had a cancerous tumor size of a grapefruit on her liver. And she goes under the power, and she was screaming, I'm healed, I'm healed. And I said, I believe you are. She went back to the doctor, and the doctor said, I still see it on the x-ray. She said, but you can't see it on the x-ray. He said, I see it on the x-ray. And she said, I was so discouraged, I was ready just to quit. And they said, we have to do immediate surgery. When they got in to do the surgery, all of the tentacles on the tumor had been already cut. The tumor fell into the doctor's hands, and all the cancer cells were dead. Now, and then the doctor got born again. Now, my point is, see, I'm saying that tonight is a true story. I have their names. It's a true story. But you don't know why you're hearing that. That's something you store up. Well, I'm going to remember that story. You remember stuff that is said here. You may need it. You may need it for your daughter. You may need it for your ex-husband. We help our ex-husband. Come on, say amen. Oh, wow. I don't know about that one back there. Sounds like she wants her ex-husband back again. That's what that sounds like. What a church. Don't know when to quit loving people, I tell you what. This is amazing, though.
It is, because when I went through breast cancer, I went through all the treatments.
Horrible
and everything.
Thing. Oh, my.
And all the chemotherapy, all the radiation. And I came in the middle to a service, a healing service, and you prayed over me again.
Yeah.
And I just kept thinking, okay, I'm going to get through this. But when I came through all the chemotherapy and radiation, they said my heart was damaged and it would never be repaired.
See, you never know how he's going to do it and how he's going to, what he's going to use to do it. Give no glory to vitamins. Give no glory to anything other than him. He will use anything to get you well.
I just kept putting the word of God in and
You're
putting
beautiful.
The word of God in and putting
well,
the word of God in.
There you go.
And the night before I went to the heart specialist, he said, I just had fear come all over me like a wet blanket. And I just stayed up all night long saying the 23rd Psalm over and over and over again. About 2:30 in the morning, it all lifted. I went back to the specialist, and he said, what have you been doing? And I said, well, there's kind of a problem. I said, I took the medication for about 2 weeks, but I fell asleep all the time, and I didn't like it. So I started walking every day, and he said, I told you not to get any exercise, just to rest your body. Just to rest your body. And I said, well, I've been walking for miles every day.
How long? How long?
Miles. I just started walking.
And what he told you not to do.
He told me not, just to rest my body. Mm-hmm. But I just thought, my heart's a muscle, so I need to exercise. Mm-hmm. So I started walking and walking further and further and further every day. And he said, well, whatever you've been doing, your heart's totally healed.
Do you tell anybody this story?
I tell it everywhere I can. People are always telling me, I have a friend that's with me tonight, and she always says, do you always tell so many stories? And I was like, well, I've got lots to tell. She said, you should write a book. And I said, yeah, but I'm not a writer. I'm a storyteller. I can tell you a story because of all the things the Lord's done.
Right? Where do you live?
In Peterborough.
So this is your church?
Yes.
Put your hands up. I just give God praise for you, but there's money coming to you. You have money coming.
Some more, is that what you're saying?
Of everything she remembers the fight part. First, receive it with joy. Worry about the fight tomorrow morning. Come on, somebody. Wow. There's money coming.
I can use some, yeah. I can really use a vehicle. My vehicle's not safe to drive. I have a friend that gives me a ride to church.
So you need a vehicle.
Yeah.
She needs a vehicle. Just put your hands up. This I heard it so quickly that there's money coming. They're going to lay it at your feet. Treasures will be laid at your feet. You can buy your car, your truck, your Jeep, whatever you're going to buy. And this year, it's this summer, before summer's over. It would?
My son keeps saying, how are you going to do this? How are you going to do this? You don't have any money. I said, God's going to make a way. He's always made a way. He's going to show up. He loves me. And you're going to see it.
Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look for in his wonderful. Come on, and the things of earth. And the things of earth will grow strange in the light of his glory. One more time, everybody. Come on, turn your eyes. Come on. Turn your
eyes upon Jesus.
Look
full in his wonderful face.
And the things of earth.
And the things of earth
will
grow strangely dim
in the
light of his glory and grace.
Don't wait till you get into trouble. Build that bridge to him now. Build that bridge. Then you won't feel strange to do it when you need help. You know? What's going on here, sir?
Billy, I'm only 84 years old, that's all. I've been a minister for 48 years.
Wow.
A year ago, I was having trouble breathing, so they sent me to the heart specialist in Ottawa, and I have one of the main arteries blocked, fully blocked. Mm. But I've been trusting in God. Mm. I'm believing that it's going to be gone, because in June, I got to go see the doctor again and see if I need to have something done with it. But I know it's clear, because I put my trust in God.
That's good.
And I believe in God's healing.
Put your hands up. He's here. He's here for a miracle. For. Why did he come up? Because he feels faith building. These stories build faith. Because the Bible is very clear. He's no respecter of people. What he'll do for someone, he'll do for you. But you got to really reach out and be humble and give him everything. These stories are, they humble us. Who likes to admit all of these things that they go through? But if you humble yourself, say, I need the Lord. He's all I need. That's the song. We sing it. He's all I need. And then we sing, you're all I need. It's true. It's so true. Touch this pastor. Touch him. Lord, he's been representing you for a lot of years. God, there's a whole lot of people in their 80s and in their 90s and past 100 that need to know that Jesus still heals. Age is no barrier. Oh, we thank you, dear Jesus. He's all I need. He's all
I need.
Come on, everybody. Jesus,
Jesus is all I need.
It's the Holy Ghost on you there, my pastor friend.
He's all I need.
He's
all I need.
There'll be no procedure.
Jesus is all I need.
Come on, you say, you're all I need.
You're all I need.
And you're
all I need.
Jesus.
Jesus, you're all I need.
But see, this here, him on the floor of the prayer, it all goes back to the very beginning that we believe he's here. That we believe that he's here. Invisible, of course, but in presence. What are you feeling right now? Do you feel him here? Let me see, how many feel him here? Yes, we walk by faith, but it would be morally wrong for God to expect us to never feel him. When everything out there in the world's governed by feelings. Everything. It's a sense-ruled world. So he doesn't expect us never to feel him. He just don't want us to depend upon him. But when you come to a meeting like this, he wants the glory to pass through you. He wants you to be open for something maybe you've never experienced. You'll never forget it. And you'll be wanting more all the time. I mean it. It's just one of the most marvelous things that could ever happen to you. It's a great way of God saying, yeah, I am here. And he may know that right now you need to feel something. Nothing wrong with that. I don't like preachers that condemn people for wanting to feel something. Drugs is a feeling. Sex is a feeling. Alcohol is a feeling. Pornography is a feeling. Everything is feeling oriented. Why would you come in here and say, no, no feelings allowed? That's crazy. The glory of feeling. Hey, sir, you okay? You all right? What's different? What do you feel different?
Everything go all over me. And the first time I've ever been slain by the Spirit is my son. He got saved that night.
Uh-huh.
And he passed away when he was 23 in 1984.
He's with the
Lord. He's with the Lord.
He's with the Lord.
And he was an epileptic as well.
He's safe. Anybody that you have that's in heaven, the thing I like about people that I know, they're safe. From this crazy world, they're safe. Come on, say amen.
Amen.
People that you love, that you'll see again, you can rest assured tonight, they're safe. They don't have any of the battles that we have. Safe. Come on, put your hands up and say that. I thank you, Lord. My relatives, my friends that knew you, that have crossed over, it's a peace knowing they're safe. I thank you, Lord. Come on, give them a mighty shout. That's powerful. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, give them a mighty, mighty, mighty shout. You know, these stories, they just don't quit. They don't grow old. And these people really were free to share them with you. And there's going to be more of those miracles here tonight. We're running out of time to do that. And one of the things that when we come here, and you know we do this, we take an offering. Why do we do that? Well, because we need your money. But you say, but don't you have any? I do, but I want yours. Can I have some of your money? Can the Lord have some of your money? Does he deserve it? Put your hands up. Let's pray. Come on. I want you to pray because sometimes you find a reason not to bless God and bless the work. This church is here. This church is such a great church all through the years. It stays open to the gifts of the Spirit. It stays open for incidences like this. A lot of churches that used to do this don't do this no more because of all the liability that goes with it. But you have a pastor here who's fearless. He's fearless. He stands for what? He stands for Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. All 66 books. And he believes in miracles. I love people that believe in miracles. Come on, give God a big, big shout.
Ushers, hold back on the offering, okay? Pastor, are you praying?
I was just going to say, give. Give like you believe that, you know, you're witnessing a miracle, that God wants you to part with some of your earnings. We're not asking for everything, but we're asking you to really appreciate these stories. That you may be a receiver of one of these tonight. Why not you? Why not now? Why put it off another day? Oh, my. Oh, my.
So as you're filling out your envelopes there, please put your names on and your offering there. But listen to this. If you can put your text on there, then especially in case an emergency happens and something can't, pastor can't get here sometime, then we can immediately let everybody know. If you already got an email from us, we already have your email. But if you didn't get an email from us, would you please write your email on? That's how we can let you know that something's happening. Email, text, and then complete your offering. Duncan's going to minister, and then in the middle of his song, I'm going to say, ushers, come forward. Okay, Duncan? Okay, thank you. You start, and I'll interrupt just quickly.
You're the same God today, and the same God tomorrow. Help me see the victory you already see. Let my faith be today what it will be tomorrow. When I see the victory you already see.
God.
all stand. Come on. Healing necks right now, people with some neck pain. Some of these necks, the bones have been actually been hurt to crack in these necks. God's healing that. He's healing IBS, irritable bowel syndrome, being wonderfully healed. There's fibroid tumors being healed right now, quickly. Fibroid tumors being wonderfully touched. Oh, the power just hit this lady by the Holy Ghost right here, just straighten her out there. Nobody caught her. She's okay. Leave her there. The power's healing that lady. Who is that lady? He's touching you, ma'am. That's the Holy Ghost on you. It's the Holy Spirit all over this lady. Those fibroid tumors are being healed. He's scraping them right off of you. There'll be no surgery needed because you're getting surgery right now. I'm looking for five happy people. Come on. Ah, the Holy Ghost. Hey. Come on, give them a mighty shout.
Hi, we have neck here.
Neck here. Let me borrow your glasses a minute. Let me borrow your glasses. See, if you're in this meeting tonight and you've just seen a couple miracles like this, I'm not you. But if I was you and I'm wearing these, I'm not leaving here until I press in a little bit. How do you do that? Do you have any other? And you go, let me just check this in. Don't take much to do that. Look at that. That might mean all that it takes for God to bless. He's looking for expectation. He wants you to expect something. He'll do all the heavy lifting, but he needs you to expect it. How many believe he's here? Come on, how many? You don't need me to pray for you. You just need to exercise your faith out there where you're standing. You know, and if you think something funny in my ear, well, you couldn't hear before, go out in the lobby and talk to yourself. Can you hear you? Ask somebody else, what do you hear here? Start looking for this. That's why we sing, I believe in miracles. That's why we sing, expect a miracle. Here's your glasses. Are you sure you need those, sir? You sure you need those? You need them what?
Be times.
At certain times.
Yeah.
They're readers.
Mostly all the time.
Are they readers or are they regular glasses?
They've got the bifocal thing.
Okay, okay. So what'd you come up for? What are you here
well,
for?
Well, I have the neck thing.
Uh-huh.
But I have, unfortunately, a litany of problems that were not, I don't want to go into.
Yeah.
There are too many.
Yeah.
And
is it hurting now?
My neck?
Yeah.
Well,
no. What's the matter with this crowd? What's the matter with this crowd?
I'm a sinner.
Don't you make me hold up a sign. This is a miracle. Don't make me do that. This should cause a combustion. Pretty amazing. He's healing your whole back.
Well, it's a difficult thing. It's too many to talk about.
He's healing you. Yeah. Don't destroy it with your word. Just say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Who are you? Well, don't say it like that.
Yes, his daughter?
I am his only daughter.
But I mean, God just touched him.
Not just a little bit, all of him. Like, all of it. Yeah.
See, what happens is, and you know, I haven't understood this my whole life either. And you learn, and anything you're in, you develop, you cultivate. But God will give you a healing touch. Don't mean you're healed. He'll give you a touch to see if you believe it, to see if you say, thank you, Jesus. Do you walk out of here and say, man, I'm so glad I went tonight. God touched me. I mean, He wants to see how you handle the money, the favor, the success, the healing, the strength. He wants to know how, you know, it humbles all of us to need an invisible God. I don't know if you understand what I'm saying, an invisible God, the all-wise, immortal, all-knowing, invisible God is who we worship. We don't worship trees and rocks and crystals and statues. Fire. We worship the God of Abraham and Isaac and Jacob. And Jesus expects that. He said to Philip, because Philip said, show us the Father. And Jesus said, Philip, how long have you been with me? You don't know by now if you've seen me, you've seen the Father. Come on, don't be a slowpoke with this. Get a hold of this. This presence you're experiencing here tonight is the presence of the living God that's in this room. And if you don't want to come up here, stand there and just receive it. And watch what happens. That lady over there, she still, what happened? She was laying on the floor there. What happened to you? Did you check the fibroids?
No, well, not really. I had an ultrasound this afternoon.
You had what?
An ultrasound this afternoon.
Uh-huh, and they said they were there.
Well, they don't tell you anything, but...
What, do you feel them?
Yeah, like, it's pretty big. Like,
do you feel it now?
Well, I'm not, like, lit. Sort of, yeah, like...
What's that mean, sort of?
Yes, it's there. I need my neck, like, fixed, too.
This mighty touch on the lady. That's the power all over you. It's all over you. It's all over you. He's touching your whole body.
Yes.
But he's healing your emotions tonight.
Yes.
That battle you're in right now isn't going to last too much longer. Declare victory tonight. Declare victory tonight. Oh my, that mighty touch. Wow. Just go. Walk around this room. Go. What's the matter? What doesn't work?
But I have like drop foot right now, so I can't really like.
Does it always there?
No, I just have like my spine's like compressed right now.
Uh huh.
Like my toe doesn't usually work.
You're taking your shoes off?
Well, you're asking, so like I can't bend my toe. Like this toe is like.
Dear lady, you're in bad shape. You got a lot of stuff going on here. Okay. You want to take your shoes off? Take them off.
Well, I was just swinging, so you're not lying. Like there's like supposed to wear like a brace for it. Every time I go to get the
brace. Just walk, just walk. Just do what I say. Just do what I say. Whatever he tells you to do, do it. Whatever he tells you to do, do it. Go. Well, look at that. Up the aisleway. Up the aisleway. Come on. Don't give me that look. Up the aisleway. Go, 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 go. Come on. Give her a God bless you. Amazing. Don't outgrow this. Keep your contact with him so simple. He said it, you believe it, you get prayer, you receive. You know, you receive it in faith if you have to. You receive it by touch if you have to. However, you just receive it. So, sir, we're doing pretty good over here. The daughter, tell me about this quickly. You lost your mother, his wife.
I'm not losing my dad.
You're not losing your dad. Oh, don't preach at him. Don't preach at him. Just tell me what he needs.
He needs his lungs.
Be soft with him. He's your dad. Be soft. Be soft.
I'm not that person. My mom was.
Okay, but be soft.
I'm the warrior.
Okay, well, the warriors, that's your dad.
He is my dad.
Just honor him.
He knows what I'm like.
Yeah, well.
I'm not new to him.
I know that, but he maybe needs a little bit of softer touch.
The Lord is healing all of him. His lungs, his cancer, his back, all of it. Yeah. He's had to have his lungs drained.
When you're praying for people, if you want to be in the healing ministry, you got to remember you're dealing with people. People. You yell at your dog. Come on, you yell at your bird, your cat. But people, you're tender with them. Nobody wants to be sick. But I know. Nobody wants to be in treatment. People are all fighting all kinds of things. We can't even see what people are fighting in this room. We're here to put hands on you and believe it's going to go away. It's a pretty big task to do. And sometimes we're running right into unbelief. We're running right into different belief systems. You're hearing voices telling you it's never going to go away. This isn't about putting a suit on and singing a couple songs. We're fighting against the odds here. We're swimming upstream. We're asking God to go against logic and reasoning and heal you before you get to a doctor. And take away your pain. When you get in bed tonight, throw away the Vicks vapor rub, for God's sakes, and the Bengay. Throw it all away. You smell like a medicine cabinet. Come on, give God a shout here. You wonder why your husband don't want to kiss you. That's it right there. You've got Vicks Vapor Love lips. Come on, somebody. This guy's getting touched right here. You feel that touch, don't you, sir? Let me talk to your dad. Let me have your dad for... Oh, my God. You're going to let her do that to me? Are you going to let her, you're going to fight her for me or what? People, you got to get serious. Come on, you got to get locked in. That day the woman touched the hem of his garment, she wasn't thinking about getting her nails done. She wasn't thinking about going shopping. She wasn't thinking, I need a bigger house. She had one thing on her mind. I got to get to the hem of that garment. Come on. You may have a lot of things going on in your life, but when you come to a meeting like this, you shut them out. Because if you don't feel good, come on, now you're weak in your body, you're fighting something in your head, or you're medicated, you don't even know who you are, then you got to get focused with this. And drag yourself down here and say, tonight this ends. Tonight we bury this. God, I'm calling on you. I'm not trying to be God. I'm not God. I'm just a vessel far from perfect. I'm the least of these. But I'm going to do the best job I can to get you in contact with the healer. Because I wouldn't be here if I didn't get in contact with the healer. You got to get serious with this. This isn't just some, let's pray for a bunch of people. Every day out there is a battle, and you need your strength. You can take all the letters in the alphabet for vitamins. Take them all. Put that cream on you, take all of them, and then you know that's not the answer. But somebody's making a lot of money off you out there. Well, they told me you need magnesium. Well, how's that working for you? Well, I need magnesium glycinate. They said glycinate's better than regular magnesium. How about healing's better than both magnesiums? I'm not against any of that. I take vitamins, but the point of it is that who gets the glory for this? He made your body. He made the first body. He just breathed into a pile of dirt. He can strengthen you tonight. Carotid arteries are being unblocked. I don't know who this is, but that's why you're having trouble breathing. That's why you're having trouble waking up at nighttime, because your arteries, your carotid arteries are blocked very high. And God's going to open those up tonight. Get down here. Come on, get out of your seat and get down here with that, with those carotid arteries. Who is it with these arteries? You better come quickly. Come, 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 come. Here she comes. It's a lady. There's three men with this. I'll tell you that. And there's three men with these arteries. Don't make your wife a widower. Get down here. How long you had this, ma'am?
Oh, for at least 5 years.
So you have trouble breathing?
Yeah.
You get dizzy?
Mm-hmm.
get up in the night.
Yeah.
You won't get up tonight.
No.
God's going to unblock those arteries.
That's good.
You got a hernia. We're going to get the arteries. That power of the Holy Ghost. My God, the power's on that lady. Look at that. Dear Jesus. Come on, give God a big, big shout. Carotid arteries here. Bring her down. What she don't hurt that lady. She just got healed of something. Don't. She get injured laying on the floor here. She leave her there, ma'am. You're okay. Come, sweetheart. Just with the arteries. How long have you had the carotid artery issue?
My daughter told me.
Your daughter
I'm
told
me. I'm 90 now, so.
You're 90. Give her a big God bless you for being 90. Wow. Wow.
I have breathing problems.
You what?
Breathing and congestive heart failure.
I'm so glad you're
with
here.
Your kidneys.
And I'm so glad you're still here
depression
at 90.
Depression, anxiety, big.
She just led a lady to the Lord back there.
She what?
She just led her lady to the
she
Lord.
She just led a lady to the Lord in the back of the church.
Wow.
Powerful.
God has work for her to do. God
yeah.
has things for her to do still.
That's your mother?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
And the devil's tried to take her a couple times the last year, but he hasn't succeeded at
She's
all.
Way exceeded the lifespan of normal. She's way exceeded that, and we're just praising the Lord for that. We touch your master tonight and ask you to unblock these. Oh, my, the power's on her, too. Let her go. There she goes. Let her go. She's 90 and still falls. Look at that. As we lift our hearts before you as a token of our love, holy, 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 holy. Everybody, hands up, come on. Holy,
holy.
Softly. Holy, 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 Lord God. You felt that? Yeah. Well, the power's still on her.
As we lift
our hearts before you as a token.
Holy.
Let her go. Look at this. That's why she's 90 right here. Precious Jesus. Precious Jesus. We're so glad that you've redeemed us, precious Jesus. Come on, as we
lift our hearts before you as a token
of our love,
precious Jesus, precious Jesus.
His name is wonderful. His name is wonderful. His name is wonderful. Jesus, my Lord. Come on, He is the mighty King. He is the mighty King. This mighty touch. Oh, Master of everything. You got it. His name is wonderful. Jesus. Come on, He's the rock. He's the
great shepherd.
The rock.
Rock of all ages.
Come on, Almighty God.
Almighty God.
Is He. Bow down, bow down.
Bow down
before Him. Love. His name is wonderful, Jesus. Oh, wow. What a presence is here. What's happening here?
I called for neck.
How is it now?
I can't feel it because I get injections every 3 months.
You get injections into your neck every 3 months, so you're kind of numb. Is that what you're
That's
saying?
Right.
So we have to wait for that to wear off.
Yes.
So you want a healing
yes.
to go.
I'm healing to go.
You want a brown
stay.
Bag that yeah. says healed.
Amen.
And we're sending you out of here.
Yes.
She's going to get a healing to go. This is in-house or takeout, whichever one you need to do. I mean it. I mean it. So many of the people in these meetings, they come, they think nothing happened, and in the middle of the night, they wake up and they think, my God, I'm not bleeding anymore. I'm not incontinent. I mean, my mattress is dry. I didn't defecate in the bed in the night. I mean, it's just amazing. You're in the right place at the right time, but while you're here, don't daydream. Get this. God has you here. It means He feels you're worth it. Tomorrow morning, we're back here at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. Whether they plow the roads or whether they don't plow the roads. We're going to be here at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. And we're going to be waiting for you. Tomorrow morning, 10 o'clock, it's going to be an amazing service. Put your hands up. I thank you, dear Jesus, for this wonderful touch. I thank you for this wonderful touch. Oh, the power just hit you. That was the power. That was the power. That's the Holy Spirit. You're very sensitive to the Holy Spirit. We thank you, dear Jesus. We thank you. This is stress. There's a lot of stress leaving your life tonight. There's a lot of answers you want to be able to give to people that you don't have. That's all of us. But especially, you're in a time in your life, you want to be able to help more people than what you physically can. All around you, there are people who are crying for help. You see people suffering, people going through this and going through that. It's affecting your body because you are an intercessor. God has marked you. Ezekiel 9:4, He has put a mark on your forehead as an intercessor in these end times. And that means He will protect you, He will keep you, and He will keep everybody in your family. Come on, somebody better give God a shout. Come on, give Him a mighty praise. I don't know what's the matter with this place. What's the matter with it? Come on, we gotta rock this house. You gotta believe. You gotta believe. Give me the lady in the purple. Right? Oh, you're here? Give me the purple, Lydia.
IBS.
What's going on?
I have, my neck has been bad for years.
See, none of this is any good if you're just coming up here to get a prayer. Now, I'm not saying prayer don't work, but tonight is the night we pull everything, all the stops out. And we say, this is the night you release your faith. To say, I'm going up there, I'm going to get it one way or the other, and I'm going to drive home with it, I'm going to wake up with it. This is the beginning of a new era. Quit treating your problem with prayer. That's not why you pray, is to treat something. You pray to get removal. Adjust your belief a little bit tonight. Adjust your belief. This is not a massage parlor. Let's go get a bit of rub-a-dub up there and feel better. One lady I was praying for, she said, ooh. I said, ma'am, that don't sound like the Holy Ghost. Oh, to me, that sounds a little not supposed to be that way. She said, keep touching me, preacher. Keep touching me. I said, no, ma'am, I think you need to go back to your seat. So you get all kind of people, but I mean, you got to believe this is faith. This is to heal you. Somebody's cortex is being healed right at the top of your spine. Your tailbone, there's a cortex, it's called. It's right there. It's been bruised, badly bruised. It's been hurting you for a long time. And you're in this room. I said, you're in this room with the cortex. Come, hurry. Oh, I can just see you're just hurrying. I can tell. Come on. I don't want to call cortex out all night. I'm waiting. Where are you? Here she comes. Oh, I'm going to get on you for waiting so long. Get up here, girl. What happened to you? How'd you hurt this? It's what now?
I don't know if it's by stress or sitting down long. Because I was an waitress in Jamaica. And I used to
you were an agent in Jamaica?
Hairdresser.
A waitress?
Hairdresser.
That's what I thought she said. Hairdresser.
And I had long hours of standing.
You had what now?
I used to have long hours of standing up. And sometimes sitting down.
Putting pressure on the spine.
Yeah.
Is it hurting now?
Barely. Yeah. I had a cream that I used.
No, it's going to go away. You're not going to need the cream.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
You're not going to need that cream. You're not going to need it. Come on, give God a shout. Come on,
somebody.
Woo! My God. Amazing. What happened here?
So my issue is neck. It goes right into my spine. It warps every different way to make me stand up straight. It's been forever, my whole life.
Lyme's disease is being healed. Somebody with Lyme's disease being wonderfully healed. Hurry, Lyme's. Lyme's disease. Where are you? Where? Get her back here. Come on, lady. We're going to send Uber after you. Come on. Come up here. How long you had the Lyme's disease? Are you being treated for this or what?
Yes, with herbs.
With herbs.
But it's complicated because it affects all kinds of things.
Yeah, I know Lyme does. It's horrible.
Gastrointestinal. And
that can burrow into you and really create issues, right?
Yeah.
Anything in you is going to die tonight. Die.
Thank you.
There'll be some of this drop out in the toilet. You will see stuff in the toilet.
Okay.
Don't get alarmed over that. That's a sign that what I'm saying is true. What church do you go to?
I go here.
Then let Pastor Brian know as soon as you see stuff in the toilet.
Okay.
Get your iPhone out. Take a picture of that stuff in the toilet. We'll put it up on the screen. My God, come on. You know, you say that because you know what the trouble is today. We need believers to believe. There's people who come to our crusades, unbelievers. They believe more than believers. I mean, Jesus didn't heal one Christian. None of them were Christians at Jesus. He hadn't gone to the cross yet. The blood hadn't been given yet. There was no blood put on the mercy seat, so they were still in their sins. Everybody in Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Not till after the resurrection did that blood, come on, say amen. But before that, they were all healed on credit. Abraham was counted, just his righteousness was what cleansed him. His faith was counted as righteousness. He's a merciful God tonight. Quit ruling yourself up because you don't think you qualify. The fact that you're here and you have a need, what a great way to start your journey with Jesus. On day one, I got saved and healed on the same day. That one lady over there got healed and money's coming her way. Where'd she go? I haven't seen her since. Where'd she go? She's getting her bucket list, yeah. Remember your favorite preacher, lady. Remember your favorite preacher. This is the man. Tell me about it. Is it still there? You don't feel it?
It's kind of shaking.
Your legs are shaking. That's the Holy Ghost, right? That's what that is.
Praise
you don't
God.
Have the pain anymore there, right?
No, not
you don't have it.
Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
Enjoy that vibration. Enjoy that. There's a song called Good Vibrations. Enjoy it. Amen? Come on, give God a big shout. Come on. This lady here. Put those hands up. This is for the Lyme's disease, right? Look at me. This is going to be real. This is the real signs and wonder, not just a healing. It's going to do something for your faith, for God to take this stuff out of you. You hear me? This is going to be soon. This is going to be dragged on for a long time. This is very, very, oh, that power. Wow. Come on, give God a shout. Come on. Come on, you got to give him all the praise. Wow.
Neck, spine, and IBS.
We charge for that, my lady. My God. We'll send you a bill,
honestly,
huh?
The spine thing would be amazing.
The spine thing.
Yeah, because even years ago, 20 years ago,
is it hurting
I had an X-ray.
Now?
It's just stiff all the time.
Like, is it stiff now?
It doesn't.
It stiff now?
A little bit like in the back here, sort of.
Mine's
because it's
stiff
like
all
not,
a little bit, too.
Not
that,
the,
that power. Oh, my God, the power hit that. Did you see that? Did you see that? You almost didn't catch her. We pay you a lot of money to catch these people. He's healing you, ma'am. He's healing you, ma'am. You give him your ashes tonight, he's going to give you beauty. There's an exchange going on here tonight. There's a new season that awaits you. oil of joy for mourning, garment of praise for heaviness. Just God wants you to make that exchange tonight. Don't be that same girl anymore. Refuse it. Quit answering the door to the wrong person. Quit listening to the wrong voice. Stop it. God come to set you free tonight. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Come on, give him a mighty praise. Come on. Come on, give him a mighty praise. You're good. That's good. Thank you for being humble to do that. It's okay. Go ahead. Oh, geez. His name is Jesus.
Jesus.
Come on, everybody. Hands up. Jesus. There's just something about that name. Come on, he's my master, he's my,
master.
That's been done to you is not beyond repair. And you've got to quit thinking it's beyond repair. Ephesians 2:10 says, you are his workmanship. That's who you are. You're his workmanship. The Greek word, there's poem or poema. You're God's. God's going to bring rhythm and rhyme back into your life. You better get ready, lady. You better get ready. Those people that plotted against you, those people that said and did, and their intentions were wrong. But you're more than a survivor. You're an overcomer. I said you're an overcomer. You're coming through this. And you had to pay a high price for this, but I'll tell you what, you're going to be such a servant and such a server and such a worshiper and such a what can I do to serve my God? I mean, you're going to put a period to this battle. You're going to close the back door and their chariots are going to fall off. Some of these people are still after you. They're still pursuing you with words and judgment. It is over, lady. Come on, somebody. Come on. Come on, you better give him all the praise. She's being wonderfully, that lady there, she came out of nowhere. Phenomenal. Where was the lady that was right here? Where'd she go? How are you feeling, sweetheart? You got delivered. That was deliverance.
Very embarrassed. Like, I was so self-conscious. I was trying to stop it, but I just, you know.
You did it. You did it right.
Oh, did I? I hope so. I'm like, was that on television?
Well, that's what we're going to show tomorrow night. That's the first thing we're going to show. You signed all the releases when you came in here today.
I guess so.
You got to be humble to do that. You know what you got to do? You got to say, I don't care what people think. I want to get help. You know, when you go into a 911 at the hospital, 911 emergency room, I mean, it's like they've seen everything. Nobody judges you. And the church shouldn't do that either. There's people carrying spirits and demons that are causing them to think things and do things. That's horrific. People just don't wake up and become a serial killer or rapist. They just don't wake up and they just don't start perusing the internet to kidnap people. Tonight there's little kids that can't find their way out of a trapped place. They're calling for their mother and their father, and nobody hears them, they think. We're going to pray for them before we go tonight. Those girls in that tunnel over there in Gaza, they got to get out of there. I don't know what's happened to them, but I'd rather them get free and then have to get healed than to never get out of there. We can't isolate ourselves. We're called to the world. Come on, say, I'm called to the world. We got to get more globally minded, not divorce ourselves from all this stuff. It'll desensitize you. It'll take away the heartbeat of God from you. Thank God you're here. You're in a safe place now, but that's so you can send that signal to Him. That's when we get like God, when we operate on His level, when we begin to not think we're all the things that He thinks about. He's thinking about everybody, over 8 billion people. It's important that we understand that. This kid came in up in Michigan. He had to carry his mother to the commode. He's 18 years old. She couldn't walk. She had Lyme's disease. It burrowed into her nervous system and cut off all of her nerves. She came in a wheelchair. He's 18 years old, and he carries it, takes his mother's clothes off, her pants, her panties, puts her on the commode. I didn't know any of that. I didn't never met them before. I didn't even know that she couldn't walk. I just grabbed him and said, come on, come with me. And she just jumped out of that chair. She ran across the stage, and the place went crazy. I thought, wow, what's behind this story? When he told the story of how he carried her, put her on the commode every day, dressed her, bathed her. And this kid was just crying. He said, I don't want to see my mother that way, but somebody had to help her. When his mother got healed, I mean, this kid, he didn't know what to do. He heard about it, read about it, never seen a miracle. And yet the first one that he saw was his mother. God's going to do something to each of us here tonight to convince us that this stuff is real. Come on, this is real. You know, we may not do it in the perfect way that everybody thinks. I mean, I've been around it all my life, most of my life. And every time I leave a meeting, I say, oh, Lord, thank you for that night and clean up what I messed up. Because I'm far from knowing how to do this. There's no pros in this. There's no professionals. If it was, that means we'd be doing it. I can't heal a person. But I take this Holy Spirit that's in this room tonight, don't you dare doubt Him. You're missing the most greatest opportunity of your life to be reinvigorated, reinvented, recreated. You may have missed the boat how many times in your life, but you don't have to miss it in this season. He's putting this right in front of you. There's nowhere to hide here. Where are we going to hide in this church? It's not big enough to hide. You're here. You can question anything that goes on here. I was in that one meeting in Miami. That Hell's Angels guy came in. He was with the Hell's Angels. He was their leader. And he thought this was all, you know, flash and smoke and mirrors. And he stood there, and he's like 6'6". He was a mean dude. He was a mean dude. You know, and I love when I meet those mean dudes because, you know, there's a bigger, always a bigger, badder guy than them. But I did admit I was a little fearful. I thought, this guy here, because I didn't see he had a Hell's Angels jacket on until he stood up. Then I said, why'd I pick that guy? Because I went like that. I went, you, like that. He said, you want? I said, yeah, you. And when he stood up, I thought, maybe not you. Maybe it's the guy behind you. It might be that guy behind you. But when he came up and when the power hit him and nobody caught him and he fell on a concrete floor and he laid there. He laid there. He said, what the blank did you just do? Don't you ever mess with me again. Don't you ever mess with me. I didn't say that. I'm in awe of this God that we serve. I'm in awe of him. I've had people go in their car, they went to get something to eat after the meeting, and then they just froze. Stayed in the car for hours before they could finish going home. He's in charge of all this. He's not here just to give you a little dabble, do you? He's here to really get on the inside of you and change the way you think. Way you live each and every day of your life while you're still alive. You have people that you've missed that they're gone. You're still here. Their security, their eternity is sealed. There's nothing they can do. With the choices they made, that's where they are. But you're still here. There's still stuff for you to do. That's why the reason you're still here. People you can pray for in your family. You know, an influence you can be to people. Right? Is that right? It's so important, so important. I mean, I was at an airport here, what city I was in, I don't know. And I stumbled before I sat in the chair, I was so tired. And I stumbled into this lady sitting there. She was a big lady, she had a granny dress on, you know, real, real thin silk dress. And I didn't mean to bump into her, and I bumped into her, and boy, she screamed, the whole terminal probably heard her. She had some choice words for me. I didn't know the lady. I said, ma'am, I'm sorry. She said, you ought to be sorry. What the blank's wrong with you? What, you should watch where you're going. I said, ma'am, I didn't mean to fall into you. People are looking at me like I'm the bad guy. I'm a preacher. I just came from a meeting. I'm tired. Leave me alone. And then I felt bad because I was feeling bad things about her because she said all that. So the Holy Ghost said, go back and pray for her. I said, oh, great. I went back and said, ma'am, I'm going to say a prayer for you. Get, don't you touch me with the, don't you touch me. I said, ma'am, seriously, this is what I do. God uses me. I want to pray for you. She says, oh. Everybody around me is thinking, wow, look at this. I put my hands on that granny dress and prayed for her. Boy, the power hit her in that terminal. Here's what she said. My God, I don't have any pain. I don't have any pain. I said, amen. What's your name, sir? Don't matter what my name is. Don't matter. And I walked away and said, oh, God, just do that all the time. Do that all the time. Shut the mouth of the lions. Come on, somebody give God a shout here. Come on. Come on, somebody here has got to really give God some praise. Come on, say, as they went, they were healed. As they went. Not everybody gets healed here, but as you go, as you walk to your car tonight, you should be checking and looking at everything that takes place here tonight. Or it could be a labor in vain episode. Anytime you're in the presence, there's always a product, a progressive act takes place. Seed is planted. This lady here is probably out. She's been out for 10 minutes. She okay? Oh, she's groaning. We give you a round trip ticket. If you go down, we bring you back. What happened to you? You love me? Okay. Oh.
Like you're such an amazing
Okay, okay. Tell me about tonight. Tell me about what just happened to you.
David, are you there, dear?
He's right here.
Okay, he can tell you about the word.
No, I want you to tell me.
Oh, okay. I was doing super good, and then I had to have cataracts removed, which was fine.
Yeah.
And they missed something. They said the blood work, and it was something to do with a vein, right?
Yeah. And giant cell arteritis.
Yeah, what?
Giant cell arteritis.
Oh, okay.
Not arthritis, but arteritis.
Uh-huh. And I can't see sideways. I'm banging on my screen.
How is it right now? You just fell into the power lady.
I know. I'm ready for more like this, you know?
You're ready for what?
More of this kind of thing. I've always been ready. But you know what? I've been around a lot of people. I've been helping them. I studied with Kenneth Copeland for 5 years. I had 18 books. I said, God, who am I studying for? I thought it was somebody else.
Yeah.
No, he said, you study for yourself. You understand the covenant. You understand everything, right? So anyway, it affects me now because I can't. What am I on that strong medicine? I've never had a problem. It took my blood sugar up.
Okay. Too so what high. What happened? Just happened here tonight.
I don't know. You tell me.
Can I say something?
I'm talking to her right now.
I'm sorry.
I want to ask you a question.
Yeah.
I think I've died. I'm not afraid of death. I had a fear of death many years ago.
What?
I'm not afraid of death. I had a fear.
You're not afraid of death.
Many years ago.
Okay.
And I've turned 82, but I don't feel young. I feel young inside.
Okay.
But
where are you from? Do you live here?
Barrie. Yes. And my sons. What am I doing? I wouldn't be here if they weren't for them. Taking me to all the neurologists.
Ma'am, just tell me what's going on.
Oh my gosh. My eye. I know.
We're friends. We just met tonight.
We've been here year after year, yeah. Many times. My eye, I can't see. And sometimes if a big bang, I can't hear. I was fine before all that. It's that prednisone that made everything happen that I never had before. Okay. My feet are swelling.
Okay, can you just keep quiet for just a second? Okay, so over here, you can't see peripheral?
No, not
this. Don't look at me that way. Just keep straight. Can you see this over here? Right here?
Yes.
You see that?
Yes.
See that?
Yes.
You do?
Yes.
But you see it?
I can see that.
You see this over here?
Yes.
Oh my gosh, lady.
This eye is perfectly sighted. Oh, I'm far sighted, and I can't see it.
You just told me you couldn't see peripheral.
Not this side, right side.
Okay. Well, then don't talk. Don't talk. Don't talk. They told Joshua, march, shut up and march. That's what he told them. Shut up. Would you be quiet? I never had this problem anywhere but Canada, right here to these Canadians. So you're shut up for the winter. We can't wait for spring. That's what it is. I give you praise, mighty Jesus. There it is, right there. Sing praises to your name. There we go.
Fibroids.
What's this? What's going on?
Fibroids.
Fibroids.
Fibroids. How long you had these?
I don't know.
Can you feel them? Can you feel them?
No. I found out.
They're inside?
Yeah. So I found out within this
just
year
receive.
Only.
Just receive. Just take a step back and just say, you know, I'm looking to you. I receive. Don't close your eyes. Look up. Say, I receive. There you go. I receive. He's getting close to you right now. You're feeling him right now. You're feeling him close right now, right now. Wow.
Fibroids and neck.
What's going on with the fibroids? You got fibroids down here? Can you feel them? Inside, internal.
Yeah.
And what's going on with your ears?
My neck.
Your neck. What's going on with your neck?
Just stiff here. I can hardly bend it forward.
Does it hurt?
Yeah.
So just move your neck now and see. I believe the moment you walk towards the healing line, the moment you begin to make a move towards the light, towards the right, stuff begins to happen. Or else it would never depend upon some one person praying for you. We're in a healing presence. You understand that healing presence? When the prodigal was walking back to the father's house, the father was running. Come on, say, the son was walking, but the father was running. When you begin to head in the right direction, you don't even have to be there yet. You're just headed in the right direction. You're in church. You know, you're reading your Bible more than you ever have. Maybe you never read it. Now you're reading it more. You know, you're saying some prayers. You're headed in the right direction. The Bible says David pursued the heart. He didn't have it. People think David had the heart of God. He didn't. He was a pursuing. He said he was a man after. He was after God's heart. He knew that was the only way that he could escape his own stuff, is to get the heart of God. And tonight, that's your only escape and my only escape, to escape from myself. I found that I tried to get away from me. I'd go to the beach to get away from everybody, including me. And then I found out that I was there. Once I got there, I was there. I thought, that's no good. You know what I'm saying? It was really weird. I'm thinking, man, I got me some Carpentone. I'm away from everybody, including me. I'm taking a break. And that ran right into me. And it ruined the whole day. I came back and told my wife, I said, I met myself at the beach. Well, she said, where else was you? Who else was you going to meet? We go to get away. God goes away to get us to run right into him. David said he led me by still waters, not to get away from the master, to get away from the hustle and bustle of life, but not the master. He's inescapable. Oh, my God, say that his presence is inescapable. You go to hell, he's there. You go to heavens, he's there. He's everywhere you go, he's there. Trying to work his plan. The devil has a plot, but God has a plan. Come on, give God a big shout here tonight. Come on. Come on, give him a mighty, mighty, mighty praise. Oh, that power! Come on, give God a shout.
Neck and spine.
Neck and spine. Come on here, Grandma. Let's go over here. I don't know. You're somebody's grandma. How many grandchildren do you have? Three. What's their names?
Mason, Logan, and Jordan.
You miss them.
Sometimes. I love them.
I know you do. I can tell you're a woman of great love. I can tell that about you. I'm glad you're here tonight. What do you need? Why is this your wheelchair?
Yes, it is.
You're normally in it?
Yes.
Why are you not in it now?
Well, I had to come down a hill.
You what?
I had to come down a hill.
Okay.
And it would have been zoom right into the...
So tell me what you need. What do you need?
Well, in the early 2000s.
To what?
2003, I had two really bad falls on ice, and the discs in my neck fused together. And I was just diagnosed a few months ago with spinal stenosis, severe spinal stenosis. And that means there's a hole in the bottom of your spine that the...
Where do you hurt this right this moment?
Oh, my, all across here.
Where do you hurt this moment?
My lower back and my legs.
Would you tell me where right this moment? Right this moment, check it.
Well, I'm more weak.
Would you check that back?
Well, oh.
It's not there.
No.
Somebody help me. Somebody help me. Hey, man. What do you think of that? Are you a visitor tonight? You can't hear? No, you don't hear too well.
My hearing aid is not working.
Your hearing aid isn't working. Are you a visitor here tonight?
Yes.
Are you a visitor? Is your church? Is he with you?
Yes.
Who is he? So he's visiting. You want to get that ear healed?
I can hear you. Yes.
Well, I can tell, but not real good.
I can't clear the words.
It what?
I cannot clear the
words. You can't hear the words.
Because of the hearing.
What's use of hearing if you can't hear the words?
Because of the hearing aid.
Yeah. Why don't you come out here and we'll get that healed? I need a band-aid. I cut my thumb on that lady's glasses. Here we go. Hold that. Which is the worst ear? Which ear is the worst?
Worst.
They're both.
Both.
You got hearing aids in there?
Both.
Take them out. What's your dad's name?
Louis.
Louis? Okay, Louis. Louis Luau. Louis. Thank the Lord for this. What a great night this is. I'll tell you. Injured at the altar. That out, Nick, and put that. I touched that precious lady and her. There we go. I don't want to get that on anybody. Okay. You what? You make a good nurse. Don't talk like that. There's a lot of male nurses. I'm getting injured at the altar here. I'll tell you what, this is a different night. There we go. Put your hands up. Did you take your hearing aids out? Did you take your hearing aids out? How much do you pay for those? How much do you pay for those?
Thousands.
Thousands. The power of the Holy Ghost, I give God praise. I praise God the healing of these bones. And I break that deaf and the dumb spirit. I break its power. Get out of these ears. Get out of the lobes. Get out of there. Oof. Hello. What?
I can hear you.
Somebody better give God a shout in this place. Come on, what's the matter with you? You hear that? Look at this. What do you think of this? What do you think of this? Jesus.
He is the healer.
He is the healer.
He's my healer.
He's your healer.
He's my
I heard
everything.
You. He's your what?
Everything.
Everything. Are you glad you came tonight?
Yes.
You're going to come tomorrow morning?
Tomorrow morning.
What? You coming tomorrow morning?
Tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning.
We'll try. I'll try. Once in Toronto, you did the same thing. You put me down.
Oh.
On Down Mills. Way back.
Way back. So he was at one of our other services. Many times. I'm so glad you got help tonight.
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
You can hear me.
I can hear you.
Somebody better get happy. Somebody better get happy. Come on. Thank you. It's 10 o'clock. I know you're thinking about the snow. Don't think about the snow. But we only have a little bit of time to go. Give me 10 more minutes. Can I have 10 more minutes? And then I want you all to come down to the front down here. And I'm going to pray over everybody down here. And I want to pray especially for cancer. If there's anybody here with cancer, I'm going to pray especially for cancer. Okay. But give me a few minutes. Give me a few minutes, ma'am. Calm down. Let's do hallelujah, Duncan. Hallelujah.
Yeah. Neck issues?
Okay. Master, I give you praise. I thank you for this. A little slower, Duncan. A little slower.
Hallelujah.
That's it. Beautiful. 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 There it goes, man.
Hallelujah.
By the power of the Holy Ghost. Come on. I'm going to hurry here. Come on. The power. The power's here. Oh, my gosh.
Hallelujah.
What's going on here, young girl? Why do you think that is? Did what?
Hallelujah.
put your hands up. You're not going to carry that side of your mom's family, okay? That curse is going to break tonight. There's too much destiny in you for you to be like that. You hear me? It's going to break tonight. That, oh, my God. Oh, that power's going through this girl again. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. Come on, sing it with us. Hallelujah. This mighty touch of the Holy Ghost. Oh, my God. Where? Put your hands on mine. What? Huh? It is better. Hallelujah. It's power. It's a power. It's the power of the Holy Ghost. Put him flat. Put him flat. What? Would you listen to me? What? Pretty good. Yeah. Huh? Yeah. Come on, say, I receive healing from Jesus. He's my healer. He's my Savior. I accept Him tonight in my heart. Look at that. It's amazing. Where are you from? Peterborough. Okay. Oh, go like that.
Thank you, Jesus.
Do it.
Thank you, huh? Jesus.
Come on, give God a shout. Hey, sir, what's going on here? Where at? Myeloma, multiple myeloma. Okay. Holy Ghost, we pray for healing through the bones. Let the healing power go through the bones. If that same body that dwells in me, He will quicken your mortal body. Oh, come on, hallelujah. What kind of cancer? Lung? Stage 4. Duncan, just a minute, just a minute. Can you play strings on there for me, Duncan, some strings? Listen to me. So what are they telling you?
I had 3 to 6 months to live in 2022, and
you've outlived that.
I did, and had to go through emergency brain surgery in November.
Brain surgery? Was it cancer in your brain?
Yeah, so the lung cancer spread to the brain, and they found 40 to 50 lesions. I did radiation, and now I'm doing chemo.
I hate to close this meeting. I know it's late. We're gonna be here tomorrow morning. There's just such a flow going on here tonight. I need you to come back. That's all I can say. I'll be ready to go here at 9:45, 10 o'clock. We'll hit it straight. We're on to something here. Something's about to break out. Something's about to break out. Too much is happening in one night for one night of glory for this to take place. How many would come back tomorrow morning? Let me see. How many come back another time and do a couple nights? Let me see here. Next month or something. Let me see. Yeah. I want you to live. Where do you go to church?
I go to Port Perry.
Port Perry.
Emmanuel and Port Perry.
Emmanuel and Port Perry.
Yep.
Put your hands up. Master, sweep through this soft tissue. Sweep through all soft tissue.
Thank you, Lord.
Touch the soft tissue. Let the doctors be amazed. Look what the Lord has done. Let her experience manifestation in her body tonight. Tonight by the Holy Ghost. Oh, my, we give you praise. We thank you, dear Jesus. Dear Jesus, we thank you. And we rebuke the spirit of death. You can't have this girl one day before she's supposed to go. Come on, give God a big, big shout. Can you do that? What's going on here?
I've got a wrinkle in my left retina.
Right.
That has been bugging me for 10
years. Come on, let's all stand to our feet. We're going to come down to the altar here. We're going to close in a couple of minutes.
I can't see properly in my left eye because of this wrinkle.
That's about to change. That's about to change. We give you praise, Jesus. Yeah. Oh my, the rod and the cones are being healed. The rod and the cones are being healed. The rod and the cones are lining up. I believe you're going to see just the way you're supposed to. It does. What do you think of that?
It's pretty good.
Give God a shout. Come on. My God. Come on, everybody sing hallelujah. Come on, everybody. Hallelujah. If not, you'll land into somebody. But there's a presence here. This is about presence. It's about surrendering to presence. It's a beautiful thing to watch. Even more beautiful to experience. We thank you, dear Jesus. We thank you, dear Jesus. Let him fall on you. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Power fall, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let your power fall. Beautiful.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you,
be here tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock. I hope you can make it for this service that concludes this visit here. We're talking about more meetings next month. But I want you to pray with me tonight. I want you to put your hands together, bow your heads for a moment. I want you to pray this prayer where you're surrendering to Jesus and you're going to get a cleansing prayer. It's not a healing, it's a cleansing. That's what he does. He doesn't just heal, he cleanses. He can remove that guilt from your heart and that from your mind. He can give you peace where there's been torment. He can heal memories. He really can. You may not forget the memory, but it won't cause you any pain anymore. He'll remove the poison from the memory, where it cannot condemn you because the blood has touched you. Pray with me. Say, dear Jesus, I need cleansing tonight. Help me do the right thing. I am so sorry. I have yielded to wrong. I've given way to darkness. It's trying to take me over and ruin my every day. I need the grace of God to fall on my life. I need a head start tonight so my will can be activated and my faith can begin to work again. I want my faith to work. I want to be pleasing to you. You're unlike anybody that I've ever met. Nobody loves me any more than you do. And you know me best. It is mind-blowing. Thank you for loving me tonight. I accept you tonight as my Lord and Savior. I rededicate my life from this day forward. And I ask you, Lord, give me a hunger. Give me a hunger to know you more, to know your word more. I promise I'll give you the very best that I have. In Jesus' name. Come on, give him a thunder of praise. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on, give him a thunder. Come on, a mighty, mighty thunder of praise. Oh, come on. Is there anybody around this altar that you're getting better vision as you stand, or your eyes are getting more clear? You're hearing better. Anybody else? Something happening to some people here. Raise your hand. The moment something's happening, is there anybody being touched right here in your back? Anybody over here? Quickly. Anybody? What's happening here? You feel the Lord. Okay, who else? Anybody else? Anybody can say, I feel a little bit better. I'm seeing better. Right here, what's the matter? What's better? What's better? Everything. Everything's better. That's a pretty big statement. Who else? Anybody in the center here? Yes, ma'am. What? Your back is better? No more pain? Wow. Anybody over here? Anybody in the... Yes, ma'am. Your back doesn't hurt anymore. Wow. Beautiful. Anybody else? Yes, ma'am. A burning on the head when we are praying for a memory. Wow. That was a curse that was breaking. That was a curse. Yes, sir. Memory. Oh, I love it. Anybody else over here? Way over on that side? Yes, ma'am. You can see? What was wrong? You're short-sighted? You was short-sighted. Get over here, short-sighted. Get over here. Get over here. I want to hear you. You're so far away. See who? Up in the balcony. Do you hear this? You did exactly what was said and you got it. See there? Sometimes it's just a matter, it's that simple. Wow. And that's your husband over there? Come on over here, Mr. Husband. She can see everything you do now. Everything you do, she can see. No more getting away from anything.
Much better, yeah.
Isn't it amazing?
Actually, she gave me the glasses. I kept them in the jacket. So she told me she could read.
I could read that, so I could remove them and see, remove and read, and I could read that before I could. I needed my glasses.
Now I don't think I'll be escaping again because she can be seeing me running away.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Tomorrow morning, anybody else over here? Anybody else? Quickly before we... Give God the testimony. Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much. I want to get that testimony. Linda, Pastor Linda, can we get her? Okay. What's, ma'am? What's the matter? Your shoulder. Was it hurting for how long? A long time? 6 months. That's a long time, 6 months. No pain there now. Wonderful. Wonderful. I love it. Now's the time. Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. mentally.
But God hit me so hard. I believe it's all gone. I'm 87. I still drive.
Come on, what's the matter with this crowd? Wow. Wow. Ma'am, what happened? Did you hear something or feel something? What happened?
Missionaries. We've been 30 years to India.
Is that your wife? Or?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Well, she's more excited than you, I'll tell you that.
I'm excited.
You better work on him.
I fasted the 4 days for him.
She fasted.
Praise God.
Amen.
Wow. I'm waiting for anybody else quickly before we close. I just don't want to miss one story. Yes, where? Who's the hand? I can't see it. Yes, ma'am. You're less tired. Beautiful. The bones in his neck. Where's that daughter at? Oh, daughter. Don't you ruin this, daughter. You help me. Don't ruin this. Don't you be nice to that man. You butter both sides of the bread, okay? Both sides. Oh, my God. Look at this lady. She's still going under the power. Get her. There she goes. Wow. In Compton, up there where Jerry Paxton. Yeah, yeah. Our Father. Yes. Yes. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Let's go, Duncan. Our Father.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come. Give us this day.
Give us this day.